Like tangerine orange, with a nigga drop a yellow shit, look like grapefruit that forced the boys go out past your ass. Get on track and I mash your ass. Man, these diamonds, these VVS, that shit you rocking like plastic glass in that Hellcat car. I turned it over, came back throwing an orange Nova. Hell yeah, I got a bad bitch, but I still jack my dick thing in the Oprah. They asked me, they were like, you know, what do you want to do? I told them, you know, I ain't gonna let y'all write it. You know what I'm saying? Because that's some bullshit. You're not finna be talking crazy, throwing no drinks and shit on me. Hitting me in the face and wrestling over the strippers and shit. I'm not doing all that shit. You fuck around and hit me with that camera on when that motherfucker off. I catch ass at church and I'm gonna give you a 3-piece.
Teacher, I'm glad I ain't the only one up here talking to prostitute Pippin.
Prostitute Pippin, man. Follow
man, this
pump.
Is the 85 South Show, man. This is a podcast for niggas who smoke a black
this
mouth.
This Bankhead
all the way down
podcast.
To the plastic. This is Bankhead.
Bankhead
shit.
Podcast today, man.
Shout out to Wayfield.
Real BP stuff. Motherfucker. Bankhead
hold
Podcast.
Up, hold up.
Yo, I said, boy, you got to come take this charge. I said, folk gonna let me get out. My mom had a balloon. I used to always say, oh, man. Then that hoe said, man, where your, so my mama came up there. I'm trying to keep the little y'all like, wake up, my mama gonna be getting my shit back. She was like, man, you got a parked car? I said, yeah, man, I ain't see the motherfucker, you know what I mean? I'm riding on the street. I called her. She was like, yeah, man, you gonna get my motherfucking car fixed. I said, I'm gonna get our car fixed, mama. Quick, I had Jawana pull up. I had one hotel. One of my hoes told me no, and then pulled up anyway. And then one of my other hoes said, yeah. So when the Nall pulled up, she see the yeah. I said, man, she went in. They sliced shot a fade that night. We had to take her to Grady.
Damn.
She hop out there, check my little brother, check the whole 4C, and jump out the car. That nigga had charge and everything. They got them, they sliced shot her. I had to take shot a Grady.
Damn.
Did my ex slice my new hole. I was like, damn. That shit was cap.
That nigga go.
Look at this shit. All the shit we ever want to see, because we just in a court. Don't play no games, but we got real drink on them. Not going here playing.
The Lord wants us, what Jesus said. We should be in one accord.
Line that shit up, Carlo.
What's up, fam page?
There you go.
What up?
Nah, I ain't fucking with that weed, man. I be coughing all day.
Yeah, you know, I've been out here trying to find my lungs.
Bro, what the hell going on?
I'm under pressure.
You, man.
Under pressure.
Fat pain, man.
Yeah, you tell me. I was dope like the other day and cut my hand, man. I need to stop. I need to stop. Bro, don't like you got there. Y'all don't like nothing. Then cut my hand.
Hey, get what?
Hey, you tell her.
I'm about to get real country. I'm about to put that bitch on the deuce. What
me sound like? You got a man in the trunk.
You got a man in the trunk.
Yeah. Oh, you ready? What's up?
Yeah, I had to go.
I know you.
What that guns at?
Everybody would have had a real job, we wouldn't be smoking. I damn sure wouldn't.
Everybody out here self-employed.
Oh yeah, self-employed.
We all entrepreneurs.
All entrepreneurs.
We pull them niggas into the shit. Nigga, come on, be jobless. Come on, hit this shit. You know what I'm saying? Now I'm gonna
come on, be jobless. Might as well quit. Man, let's knock this shit out. Look at you.
I got dip in a minute anyway.
Yeah, you hear everybody?
2479 Abner Terrace.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you talking about Flipper Tumble?
I still remember my Flipper Tumble address. That's a
problem. Yeah. Hey, we won't hear whatever the fuck. If you won't take us through goddamn Dro journey.
Who that motherfucker
is. Hey, we with it.
Let me tell you something. I have listened to a Young Dro album. And when you get to the end of the album, you like, man, that nigga Dro stay everywhere, bro. Dro be like, but you know a nigga really from Pittsburgh. Yeah. Know a nigga really from Bankhead. Know a nigga really from DLF. Like, that nigga from everywhere, bro. That nigga, the only thing I know is ready for the city, bro.
Listen, we kept getting put out.
Hey, real talk. No, nigga, really with the clay coat, but I only stayed 2 days. I ain't really for the clay coat. I was like, oh, now that's a real west side, nigga. I
was staying
2 days,
boy.
He had to come back home.
I gotta go.
He gotta go.
Them folks kicked in our door out there. Chill, hot as hell in Clayco, boy.
Oh, man.
Hell yeah. I think I was about 19. We had.
I be trying to swab
it
now.
I was sitting there about that. Jet came through for it to get some over some carpet and some AC. You feel me? Okay. And so they give us Ren Crossing, right across from Riverdale Middle School. We get out there, tip out there. I'm like, shit, I know shots from. You know what I mean? Woo, man. We was on Campton with it. And okay. Brown Hall with it. You feel me? We was on that with it. But we were front bank here. So really, I said, shit, that's somebody I can link with. But we link up. But tip so high, man. I'm on the phone talking to a little chick I went to therapy with. I'm like, yeah, boy, we be out here kicking the goddamn. But the police just came down my butt tip, though. They just kicked in here, though. She was like, she was like, where y'all? I said, we just seen them, and we ain't the door kick in. I'm like, they had out, though. You feel me? I was like, damn, man, the fool brought the German chefs all in. I said, man, you better not let that dog in my mama bed. The dog get on the bed. They got them fine. All kind of put out blunt, man. They locked my ass up, man.
Now, what grade y'all was in?
We wasn't in no grade. I had none. See, I stopped going to Sterocite. The shit bag opened in Claire one day, and I just went with it.
Damn, it opened on you?
Yeah, motherfucker opened up. So I said, shit, I ain't going back to school. That shit was stank as a motherfucker.
So you had not got shot and had a shit bag?
Had a shit bag, yeah. When, you know, I was able to go back to school. I got shot in the ninth, you know what I mean? When I was in the ninth, you know,
you said that on song.
You know, they put me in the 10th because I got shot, and I ain't do shit then. So I get when I went back to school. I'm sitting in class. I had already had to go to the bathroom, my bathroom up. You feel me? I asked already, so later, like, I know he ain't finna volunteer that shit again. So I was like, but this motherfucker stink. I ain't give a fuck. I just got up and left. I was like, I'm not doing that. So we got a home tutor for a little while.
Damn.
Hey, man, what better way to start the show off than talking?
They don't know. See, this
real hood shit. Real Atlanta shit.
This shit bag bust open.
Yeah, in class.
In class.
In theory.
Did it, like, over bust or over?
No, look, the motherfucker had that. You know how you can smell yourself or anybody smell you.
You were being honest. Nigga was being honest.
You so goddamn stay. Yeah, I don't like, yeah, to be honest, I smell like shit right now. You know, they just call me shitty beer from Canterville. You know, check. Call your ass stayed out there before this thing.
From yeah,
I picked that motherfucker up in McCannville. You feel me? But everywhere I go, if I smell it, I'm out of there. You know, that shit fucked my life, though, for a minute. But after a while, nigga was like,
in the street.
Yeah, nigga was like, if that shit happened to you, then nigga, we ain't fucking with you. I'm like, yeah, and take that, goddamn.
Hey, man.
Damn. The motherfuckers be trying to make sure like Chipman from the west side, man.
I don't compute that. I know my partner from the west side.
We were talking.
Yeah, man. I'm talking about his descendants is from over there. So, you know, the granddad is in the goddamn. You feel me? You know where I shouted from. He ain't got no, you know what I mean?
Nigga, I remember when it was like 03. Mm-hmm. My sister, my cousin graduated from Doug. They 03. And I'm little head. What grade I was 03? I was in fifth grade. Mm-hmm. And I was like, who the fuck that is? Like, it's a light-skinned nigga. They over there taking pictures with a light-skinned. That's all I knew. I'm like, who the fuck that little light-skinned nigga? Yeah, they taking pictures. This had to go on Doug graduation. You feel what I'm saying? They said like, oh, my God. I'm like, who the fuck is this nigga, man? And before you know it, that's when all that, I said, that's the nigga from the graduation. And that was my first moment up to it.
Shout out to Real West Side.
Man, we got to give an intro. This is another episode of the 85 South Show. Welcome back.
Welcome back, man.
Salute Chipotle, nigga, was hungry than the motherfucker, man.
Hey, man, you know
that
how we do it, man.
That nigga gave me one for it, bro. That Chipotle was good.
Hey, we back in
the... that's just all I gave you, nigga. That's all you asked for, motherfucker.
Back in the studio today, man, with our ATL partner, man.
Oh, man, ATL legend.
ATL legend.
One of the coldest rappers out of the city, man. Man, show some love. Young Dro.
Young Dro.
You just can't call out a side for Young Dro. If you ever listen to a Young Dro album, listen to me. The man is from everywhere, man. You'll hear the first song, he'll be like, boy, real nigga from McCannville. Now nigga really from Bankhead. Now nigga really from Atlanta. You be like, that nigga from everywhere, man. Yeah, my mic done with that motherfucker. Yeah.
I told you, man.
The higher your eyebrows go, the more.
There we go. Hey, yeah.
All right, now we can get this shit jumped off for real.
Yeah.
Hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, babe. That's how I practice.
Oh, went out again.
It went out?
Went, mine went out.
Yeah, it sure did.
Check, check.
That shit blowing?
That shit ain't talking about nothing.
Nigga, every time I go somewhere, and I hear that Bankhead Westside, if I'm out of state, and like the people in
it
the crowd,
it make you feel at home.
They can't relate to that one specific line. Y'all be like, "Babe," I be like, "Shut the fuck up!" Yeah. I'm really from that shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like y'all ain't know about that shit, man. Yeah, so that shit made me feel good, man. Every time I hear that shit,
man. Good, when me and Clayton first started doing comedy, that's all the fuck we listened to.
That was
to
the soundtrack. Was young riding Joe, around, bro. From everything from the mixtapes.
Pimp Squad album.
Come on, man.
I don't know about that Pimp Squad.
My nigga. Car just died. Yeah. The brain blowed out. Yeah. Ghost committed suicide. Yeah. The man in Detroit. Yeah. Come on, bro.
Ooh, that boy know so his shit. Deep, bro.
So many hits. That's who he's riding around listening to, man. That's and you one of the most, like, I don't think the South get enough credit for
versatile
lyrics, man.
Especially when it come to niggas like you who come really on, come with the motherfucking lyrics.
Yeah.
You
paint know what pictures. I'm
saying? No, you I, really did that shit.
The shit I was raised off, you know, I ain't really. I listen to a lot of stuff, but I listen to like hip hop, like, you know, Big, pop mostly. If I had to say who did it the best, I'd say Pop did it the best. But in his own way, though, you know, you can't forget Nas and Illmatic, you know what I mean?
Right.
You can't forget the Purple Tape with Raekwon. You can't forget, you know, Born on the big double CD. You can't forget none of that shit.
Right.
That shit, you got to volunteer that shit anytime you're talking about hip hop. That's what I know, you know what I mean, from my time.
Nigga, I thought we was on the elevator to hell, nigga. Y'all ain't hear that shit.
I heard
that. I was like, my nigga, are we moving down? No, my nigga, I'm like, bro, I ain't do nothing, bro. That shit was crazy.
But you just, but you got some real colorful ass lyrics that just jump out like shit. Like
the other niggas can't do it or say
shit like
they can't.
Ricky Lake and Oprah Winfrey hanging with my mama now. Like, where the fuck? Like, where you be at in your head when you come out with this type of shit? It's just because it's like those type of lyrics that jump out to me.
I watch a lot of movies though, you know.
It's
a lot of stuff that we can't do as humans. And I just feel like I should touch on that sometimes, you know. I always wanted to be a black ninja in the hood. The only nigga that knew the shit. You feel what I'm saying?
Right. Hey, black belt ninja shit. I'm flipping off your house, too.
Yeah, throwing stars.
Nigga, why you ain't never come out with your own crayons, man? You got some wild-ass colors.
I do.
Watermelon red, nigga. We gonna do that, man.
But ain't watermelon red?
Sad blue. No.
Paint the shit in sad blue. Sad blue, my nigga.
Sad blue.
I got the blues. Grand macaroni. I'm gonna tell you
the video that I always watch.
What?
I always be on some street shit. I always find that shit when you was talking about the time when a nigga tried to rob you in the store.
About nothing. Just give me my car. You know what, the nigga come up there, we gonna come holler at you. So what, motherfucker? If you do the investigation real good, you'll know that I ain't did it. You know what I'm saying? But that's the same type of shit. Like, niggas tried me like that, but I bucked on the fuck nigga, let him know, nigga, we been doing this shit. Nigga shot me already, punter. You know what I mean? This shit here you do, this petty shit, nigga. I tried to grab that gun. If I'd have took it, I'd have probably killed him. But I'm glad I ain't take it, though. And I'm glad the nigga, you know that I don't play that shit. Like, next time he'll know. Either you gonna go in here and shoot me, nigga, don't come up to me trying to do all that fuck shit. Do what you gonna do and get the hell on, nigga. I ain't gonna die about it. I'll give it to you. But if you a lame ass nigga that don't know how to rob, you know what I'm saying? You need to go get your robbing skills up. Because if I'd have came to rob you, I'd have either shot your ass on sight or you, I'd have came out with something. I still had on what, $300,000 worth of jewelry, pocket full of money, still running up the street in polo, all white polo. You know what I'm saying? My shirt was tucked in and everything. I jumped the fence and I still was fresh, like, had my glasses on and everything.
I mean, my shit moving.
Is that Latin girl? Try to take that shit. Right. Come back after. God damn it, I want to be in on this episode, man.
Where you got to go?
For real.
We got to go do some shit for Comedy Central.
Man, I'm trying to get this Comedy Central 30 minutes pressure, man.
Oh, go ahead. Do your thing, bro.
I'm going to take this shit at the Latin girl. I'm going to be back through here afterwards. Y'all might
you about to tape your shit now?
I mean, I'm just taking it so I can submit the shit. I got to submit the shit by the 15th, so.
Oh, go do your thing, bro.
All right, now, and he leaving. Just use
Clayton
money. Yeah,
just
get that paper,
baby. Damn, bro. You knew all the lyrics.
Hey, bitch, I fuck with you long, and I don't want to leave this shit. I'm about to watch you repeatedly. Make sure you let that nigga tell some of them stories that ain't nobody got.
Right.
I just want you to say the lyrics to his life.
Hey, nigga, I know all this shit's
Hey, word. I appreciate that, man.
All right, Clayton.
All right. Bro, that's really all the fuck we listen to, man. To this
my favorite fucking part. I know they love the fucking music.
You gotta tell
I like
the, whole
the fucking
story
hood stories.
Go ahead.
I used to always catch all the gangster shit. Yeah. This nigga said, I remember you on YouTube talking about a nigga trying to rob you at the store, and you got a book down on. You were like, fuck me. I went to school. Like, the shit was so funny the way he was talking about it. So I was like, man, the nigga didn't talk about it. He got robbed, but he making it funny as hell. Like, I wanted to be there to see. God damn, now my shit loose neck, goddamn. So now I'm like, damn. So he talking about I heart the fin. Yeah. And then I'm like, man, I can't wait to see this fuck nigga. You know, I went to school with this pussy ass nigga. And then I looked down, I'm tired of hell. They said, and this motherfucker shot through my motherfucking polo pants. I'm like, this nigga stupid as hell.
You know what's even crazy on that video?
That shit,
when the nigga
shit
looked at the end of the video, the nigga said, get your robbing skills up, fuck nigga.
Cause somebody talked that shit to me like, don't nobody be doing all that. You know Stevie Wonder Raw. You don't do the bobbing of the head when you got the tool on somebody. Like, I knew that shit. Like, that's why, I prevailed in that moment. Like, I was like, if you probably would have knew how to do it, maybe you would have had it. You probably had $300,000 worth of shit. That's what I had on, man. Shit. And they nothing in my pocket, you know what I mean? All kind of Franks on with Cartier pieces, and you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Man, looking at me, I'm looking at the man down the street like, what you finna do? Cause I just did some Superman shit, yo. I ain't either, you feel me? I wouldn't do it again, you feel what I'm saying? That wasn't no... ain't no smart shit to do. Just at the point in time, the nigga, it just my instincts, it didn't click.
You were like, that fuck nigga.
Cause we had to win the school.
Right? Move, move.
Then I signed him up. You know, they just told me, "Shot got lied to." I was like, shit, that nigga get. Cause I'm a good nigga. You don't really just be, you know what I mean? I don't go to church robbing nigga. You know what I mean? If you fuck with me, that's just like going to church robbing a nigga. Cause I'm gonna be there for you if you need me. You know what I'm saying? I got a foundation, man, to show how I feel and reflect on me. You feel me? Like, right. What I do for children and what I do for the elderly. You know what I'm saying? Like, you ain't got to rob me. I'll probably give it to you. You feel what I'm saying? Right. That's what I really tell y'all.
So, we've been going watching your ass forever. I mean, I ain't number 24, but I've been watching your ass since the fucking the YouTube video. Ever since then, I'm like, I got to know who the fuck the nigga is when you came out with your first album with the gold teeth. Yeah.
Let's go all the way back before that,
which
man.
It's crazy.
How you get into the rap game, man?
Then you say Tip came in the hood and said, come here, man.
No.
I know all that shit.
Look, no, look. It was way before Tip.
Go all the way back to the Raheem Dream and all that shit.
Yeah, by the time I had started rapping, you feel me? Me and Tip had started that shit like at the same time. But you know, he started it in a professional way. I just was an underground way of, you know what I mean? But you know, the shit was room for me the same way they were room for him, nigga. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I would boy Dank, like we I would Dank dollar for dollar today. You know, all these people were just my homeboys that knew how they had paper. Rocco, Dank. Backstack Kirk, you know what I'm saying? These folk was up there in the blow parking lot, Figure 8. These folk were millionaires, you feel me? Having real paper, and I just knew them all. And I went through, like, I got a song with Bunt, like, it's some rock and roll stuff we just look on the way over here. I got a song with Bunt B, Mill X, Monica, Juvenile, Turk. Yeah, all these folk for, before I even got the tip.
Right.
Yeah, before I got the tip, Rocco had cashed out all of that, you feel me?
Right.
Yeah, I stayed with y'all. So I had, man, $2,000-$3,000 a week, man, me, just for being there. You feel me? I ain't
Rocco the Dunn.
Yeah, the Dunn.
Salute Rocco the Dunn, because I need my 10. Hey, I damn sure stay with you.
Rocco
how
that
you
real nigga for that, man. Yeah,
I mean, like,
talk
this
and everything.
I used to live with Shawty.
Word.
Yeah, and ain't went no going. I was just a, hey, man, don't know how to rap, man. Home built the studio, put me in it. I ain't never go back home.
Really?
You know what I mean? Home kept me out there. Real, taught me how to rock jewelry. With the back, home, you, hey, this the kind of whip you need, you feel me?
What?
AMG Kitty, anytime you get paper. That one we got, like, when me and Future got paper, you like, y'all got that phone? Like, Shawty had done laid it on you.
Right.
You can't go wrong out there fucking with A1. You feel me? And Monica was down for me, so, you know, I got a chance to see broke side and, like, the millionaire side. Like, always, you know what I'm saying? I was always able to see in between. I guess that's why, you know, I'm still kind of, like, street with... Like you might go see me on TV, you know what I mean?
Right.
Volunteering my shit, you know what I mean? I might go from the trap to the television, you know what I mean? But it's possible. You know what I mean? I ain't saying you should. I'm not saying that this would fit you.
Make sure you listen, children.
this shit
been going on.
Yeah, this might not fit what you're trying to do, but this is who I am, you know what I mean?
Man, that's crazy, man. Coming up in the game with Rocco and Future.
I remember the black boy, white boy sweat. You fuck my whole
generation. Black boy, white boy sweat.
All these niggas, listen. The white tee stage grew so fast. Yeah. What?
That song got down, Young L.A. that got down. So much pain.
Yeah. He look like a wreck. Fuck wrong with you, man. Oh, when he was singing so much pain, I wanted to spray that nigga ass. So. Damn. Mama on your
that's
ass.
That's the type
boy.
Of shit we on today.
Eskimo chin having ass. What fuck wrong with you? But you look like you got a fireplace at the crib. And you sit close and fuck to that bitch. They be like, back up. Go kill yourself. You too big and don't have no eyebrow. Fuck wrong with you, boy? Hey, you lick them off?
Yeah.
Hey, you talking about? You wish you had eyelashes. Ugly ass, boy. Fuck wrong
back
with you.
Back to the motherfucker. Had to take a quick intermission for these niggas.
We try to roast you,
right, man.
I just fuck with the song, bro. I just fuck with the song.
I'm just saying, though, you looked like a fucking rat. You pulled a song at, like, with a Down syndrome. You were too heavy. I was like, that nigga a rat.
Yeah, man, that's what we got to see. What
it's your first time. Yeah. I could have sworn you been mad at that.
My boy.
We both down the west side. You ain't never seen this nigga.
This nigga be everywhere, man.
Yeah, I do.
Oh, and you lying. Oh, no, you ain't lying.
Damn. This nigga really do be everywhere, man.
I do, bro.
But, Dro, you'll pop.
But you know what, though?
You'll pop up and hit him with some shit like, we be in the city, hot ass single.
Yeah.
Lay low for a minute. Come back and hit him with another one.
I still be doing stuff. Like, but when I want to go up there, though, you know, you know, by the time I get up there, niggas will be acting like they don't see what I like. So y'all gonna act like y'all don't see this shit.
Nah, you be like, going crazy.
Nah, you always 10. Come out.
Everybody go top 10 in the country. Like,
right.
You feel me? But you know, I don't go back. I still do shit. You know, I fuck my people. I let somebody, like, I'm gonna let somebody in a couple of days, you know. Ain't gonna be no big ass, you know, no big ass promotion behind it, cause I don't really. If when I want that, I'll get that. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah.
But I'm going to tell you what they slept on, though. I did that. I feel like you should have used them verses on something else. Like, them nigga, you sit there and listen to the all verses.
Yeah.
How many you got? Three?
Two.
Yeah. Nigga. You going crazy on them motherfuckers.
Yeah, I was in that kid.
You was in your bag then.
It seemed like every song you come up with a different style, man. What's some of your influences that just...
You know, the youth really be my, like, what I focus on. Like, you know what I'm saying? Because I be in the street, like.
He really in the street. I don't like, really I think, mean, motherfucker, like, you want a rapper that really.
And I don't
I try. Hear, like, nigga, we can pull up in the same apartment, Dro with that. Ah, what you doing? That, you ugly exactly. Like, that's what we do, bro.
Yeah.
You
feel what I'm saying?
You
want
them rappers,
shit.
Bro.
Yeah, I'm one of them niggas that just be, you know, ain't no rah-rah shit when you see me. It be some street shit.
It's
like,
it's comfortable.
Try, yeah. And it, I don't be on that crazy shit either, though. Like have any nigga be. You know what I mean? Like, you can actually say something to me and that shit'll be cool. You know, I say something to you, I hit you up. It ain't no come through shit with no cameras and shit. You know what I mean?
What is it that make niggas act like that?
And they nigga would never name before they got famous. Rappers, in particular,
always get on, like, some rappers get on some whole different other shit.
You gotta think about it. If you were really out there and you were known, bro, like, And you already were getting street money. You feel what I'm saying? Like, you ain't got to be no millionaire, but nigga, you was a thousandaire. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got a couple thousand.
Shout out to the thousandaires.
Shout out to the thousandaires. You feel what I'm saying?
I like the day-to-day hustler. That is the most interesting person.
Like, every day.
That is the most interesting.
The nigga who really going out there going to get his shit. I'm talking about, he said the niche.
You catch a nigga living check to check. This is the most interesting person you can ever meet. He always got something new. You feel what I'm saying? He ain't on the same shit all the time. Then he actually coming up with new hustles. And when he do find his hustle, until then, you're going to meet a real character, man. I like that. I like a hustler.
An everyday hustler. Yeah, like no, a real. No, we ain't talking about seasonal, nigga.
No rich parents. No assistants. No help at all.
We talking about when you find a nigga who doing good, you just sit there and be like, hey, bro.
Yeah.
how you start this shit? He gonna be like, bro, real talk, bro. I broke in that nigga house. I sold the plasma, and I was just like, fuck that robbery shit, because that 25 to life. Yeah. So I took that little money and just bought some weed, and I was like, bro, I'm gonna take this shit serious, you feel me? And my baby mama was on me, had to get her $100, so I really only had an hour.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
That's a hustler. Nigga got 3-4 niggas like,
real talk, bro.
You got a lot of hustles, when you can do a lot of shit, multitask with that motherfucking skill, you feel me? Like, nigga, I had to do a lot of stuff, nigga. You feel me, nigga? I couldn't just... Niggas ain't just getting niggas no money. You feel me? Niggas ain't getting you a goddamn coin, bro. Like, I had to get out here and kick it, bro. I ain't had no job. I worked at Shoney's and Captain D before. But, you know...
Shoney's off on Fourth.
Nah, in Riverdale. Like, they weren't playing. Like, when we moved to Clayton County for, we weren't playing. I'm telling you. We had them start working there at Shoney's. And then the lady came and she... White lady happens to my, are you stoned? Tell the truth, are you stoned?
You sold some drugs.
If you're stoned, now, can't come here like that again, okay? Just like it. I looked at it, okay. I ain't get high no more. I went and I got me a job. That thing on the 4-5 because I had a grill at the top. I had my little Jesus head on with the link, you feel me? With the grill and the phone. Like, you really don't look like a cook, sir. So I said, you know what I'm saying? So I was like,
nigga, I don't dream about that cook.
Yeah, about that cook. What y'all want, nigga? You know, I got the weed and the steak. Yeah, what you want in the state? You want a nick, that motherfucker nick? Fuck you, man. I'm back there with it.
Well, look. Joe,
the 4-5. This shit,
Joe, you cooking nigga with the grill, yeah, and the chain,
man,
though.
Listen, I got nick weed, man. It's my partner, Danny Boy, he in there with me. You feel me? He kicking it. But, you know, after they fired me, I think the lady who fired us had then got caught up into some scam and shit. We was able to get, you feel me, this is how God worked. We was able to get jobs after that. Like, whoever worked at Shoney, y'all could come on up here to Captain D. So we go to Captain D.
Hey, man, they transferred you to a
nigga. They transferred nigga down the street, man. Seafood, though.
Then when I was fed up, when I seen, you know what I'm saying, I started taking the fish out of the freezer. The fish fell around and hit the ground. You feel me? The nigga was like, fuck it, get it. The manager, fuck that, get it, put it back. I said, I'm not finna put this shit back. You see how this shit now? The man was like, put it back in there, or you got them, you feel me? We're gonna have some, you know what I mean, some problems. Man, I put the fish down and got the hell on, man. I wasn't finna be serving no mopping glow with no damn fish on.
You talking about mopping glow with no goddamn fish on?
Yeah, goddamn real deal shit on that floor, man. That nigga told me to pick that shit back up. I was like, no, I'm not a part of that. That Burger King shit over there by Greenbow, I don't have them put that pee in there, goddamn mayonnaise.
Real
talk. That nutted in the mayonnaise with his ass there, huh? That nasty shit, bro. I'm not finna be a part of that, bro. I walked out. And then, you know, I thought to myself, I said, shit, man, I want to be something different. Hear me? And then I started, when we started to sell the dope, I fucked around the head, got some touch and butt, slept on the bomb. The bomb flat as a motherfucker. I'm like, I can't say it either.
You don't understand what you just see. I know. From me being in the street, you had a bomb and you slept on it.
Yeah, I slept.
These niggas don't know what they don't know what touching. They don't know what all
this. It's a dope that you really
don't want.
Don't want touching brush. It seems like you got that touching brush out there.
I mean, you touch it down at this pill.
Touch it down at this pill. I slept on it and that shit. And it's just in the 20 out of 100. That's how we were getting off a bomb. We weren't no key gillers and shit like that. Mm-hmm. You know, we sold sets and robbed J's. You feel me? I slap a J in the face for a 50. You feel me? I ain't looking to get you knocked out. You feel what I'm saying? I ain't lying. That's how we was in Bankhead and Kimberly Coat. Like, before we know that the nigga had a 4-way or 9 and a brick in there, man. J pull up, but let me get a 40. Who? Yeah, let me give me that, and then you can go try to find a father somewhere with a black eye. But you ain't get that my father right there, baby. You feel me? I'm gonna give me a bag of weed for the four. You feel me? I'm gonna spend
$1. That was Nick was in. Yeah, that was me. Yeah, was
you
in.
You gotta get popcorn mid. Bag weed for the four, then save $1, get them 2 blunts.
They don't know about that mid epidemic, but we'll smoke 30 blunts and be
we'll
like,
stretch a
Nick, no high.
We'll stretch a Nick to 2 blunt. Then real skimp.
How the fuck?
What? Yeah, that was a real deal.
But she ain't got
that.
See, but when they start, I named myself Dro after when the Dro came out.
Yeah, right. I remember that. And I remember when you came.
They had the urge in Pittsburgh.
Talk to him about Pittsburgh, man.
Man, Pittsburgh, Popeye
always had the best weed in the city,
and they were the urge originated. Like, but we was in some here with Lucci Daddy, the real roster. He had it. That was, I used to ride on the back of the truck with it. You feel me? His mama, I know shout, you know, shout out for some here. Real talk, whatever he say.
Looch.
Man, hell yeah, 1044, hey, yeah. So listen.
That nigga know the address.
Listen, man, we grind on the back home truck with the urn. So the nigga had asked us, you know what I'm saying? He was like, what y'all nigga want to get something to eat? Or y'all want to get some weed? I said, shit, we gonna get some weed. We got there. So, but that, after then, them nigga was like, we gonna call you Dro, bro. That's all you want to do. You don't even want no food. You feel what I'm saying? Like, yeah. Because the weed, it tasted. You got to hold it in. Once you get them tape boy right, if your tape good, you know what to get every time.
Every
you
time.
Walk up him. I know what it is, but I'm playing. You feel me?
Right.
Oh, you Dro, bro. All right, cool. Raheem said, you going to go with Dro? So, yeah, I went with Dro. Ever since then, you know, I went by Dro. Then when I got with the two, I think I went to Stonewall to the medical boot camp. I ain't got locked up for dirty urine.
Long probation. Time, yeah, violation. Probation,
right? Go out there and sit down.
So, yeah, Monica. Monica was, you know, popping. So Monica was on 106 and Park. She was like, my brother drove. Woo-woo. So them niggas down there, they gave me 10, 20 days off and shit. I got out. And boy, I tried.
Just because off the strength of her saying that on TV.
When we were down there locked up, you feel me? A nigga from Cleveland now started calling me Young Dro. They be like, the boy, Young Dro. So I ran with that motherfucker. I thought I was Dro already.
They turned up.
Yeah. I rap like an old man back then. My boy was deep as a motherfucker.
Nah.
I had something to prove to me. I was rapping like Pop was out too. You can't rap like no hoe. Pop was out, man.
I mean, don't say like you rapping like a hoe now, nigga.
But that shit was like, when you doing shows, that shit was like, that shit a bust a vessel, brother. The way I was rapping, you know what I'm saying?
Real aggressive type.
That shit was like Onyx flow, nigga. That old Onyx shit.
Yeah.
Real talk, man. So I'm glad shit just been going crazy. So what you got like in store? You feel what I'm saying? Like,
what's
I know you got
move?
Something in store. Because one thing about Dro, you going to keep it hit and keep something on the radio.
Yeah,
Soon they say, what Dro with? Nigga, I'm right on nigga. Cut on your radio.
Okay. It's always a strategy to, you know, success or whatever and how you want to do it. So, but the things that I have to do to, you know, present these things that you want to hear are right in the back of the car, you know what I'm saying? Like,
you telling me I can get an exclusive CD right now?
I mean, I can email it to you. I got some stuff that, you know, we just waiting till the next quarter to come. You know, it usually come around summertime. You know, around spring. You know, the hit come out around spring. We ride through summer with it.
Yeah,
you know what I mean, we'll be at 2017.
Your that's head. Your season, man.
Yeah, that is my.
You know, you still got the city.
Yeah, man, that's what I appreciate too, man. And I appreciate everybody who got something to do with the success of any record. Like Kevin Hart been playing a big role in a lot of things that, you know, a lot
I
of
I heard you on the movie, man. I love that.
When I seen the check, I want to see him get home and up, man. Hey, man, you know what I'm saying? My cheer ain't good on that.
Right.
Shit, man.
Kevin Hart been coming through with them blessings.
Yeah, man, I appreciate that, y'all nigga. That for real, like that from heart to heart. Like, I don't know how to vibe with me like that, but he do.
And then it really make this shit hype, because you know what I'm saying? Nigga want to see that shit. Yeah. Like, that's some real crunk anthem shit. Like, nigga, we here.
They played that shit in the Olympics, too.
That's what I was about to ask you, because, you know, in your music, you say a lot of crazy shit. You might say some shit like kicking it with Taylor Swift, but, like, what? Like, you ever met any, like, people who are fans of your music that surprised the shit out of you?
A lot of people, but, you know, it'd be mostly celebrities.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's mostly my fan base is really mostly popular people. A lot of people were like my music though, you know, and I appreciate it. And some people like my music for different reasons, but you know, I seen a girl one time. She made me feel really good, you know. Not like that, but
yeah,
right? You know, she went to rapping and shit. I was like, damn, a girl felt it like that, so you know what I mean? And I've seen a lot of things throughout my day, man. We've been everywhere. I've been all of Germany and Italy and shit, you know. And I appreciate the people out there. I appreciate anybody who ever wanted to have a listen for Dro. And I believe, like, really the movement started in Jacksonville, Florida. We was on the tour bus, man. And Tip, they was on there for Tip, though. They was just, you know, some shit. Everybody was on the tour bus. And goddamn, Tip just paused it and was like, no, take this out. He put in a shoulder lean. Man, that shit went so crazy, man.
Shoulder lean with that motherfucker.
What was it like to have the number one record in the country, man?
Hell, man. That shit was crazy. I can't lie. That shit was like, man, my attitude changed, though. I can't say that I was, you know, it changed me. I just got a little more cocky, you know.
But you hate
a
that?
A little more, yeah. I ain't like, I don't like that shit because, you know, that shit had me treat my people who I came up with, you know what I'm saying, kind of like crazy. I ain't trip out. I still get you a band, but I'm finna chump you. You feel me? Like, that shit wasn't healthy. And that shit, you know. I apologize to all my people that went through that era with me, you know, from, you know, I was an asshole, bro. You feel me? I swear to God. Like, yeah. I remember I told Atlantic Records, they was like, yo, we need you to come in and do something. Catch me if you can, like the gingerbread.
Damn. That's how you talk to the lady.
Yeah, with your check, you feel me?
With they check.
With your check. Like, yeah, catch me if you can. Like, yeah. But, you know, that shit, a lot of that shit. She was fun though.
Yeah, can't deny that. So, can you tell us a T.I. story? Not one that would incriminate, but just a T.I. story that don't nobody know about. You be like, man, you believe you did this shit?
Grand Hustle Family.
I mean, the story that everybody know, that the one when he got when we was in Riverdale, he got to argue with this nigga at KFC. Why he was arguing with the nigga, I don't know. You know, we used to lie to my mama to get my car. I used to tell the tip got license. Tip got the license. You know, my mama always used to want to help out with our little, you know, our little livelihood because, you know, we was some good boys overall, you know, but we could have been worse. But right. She was like, since you did that, you know, I'm going to let you just tell people this your will. You feel me? Tip used to lie and say he had license. So we get the car, get Tip at it, KLC up the street. He get into it with some nigga. I guess the nigga tried to, you know, we were blocking him in back then. You know what I'm saying? Rallies with letters on it. You feel me? Blocking him in. You feel what I'm saying? And you know, you blocking him in and get out and start cleaning them things. You feel what I'm saying? In front of him. But he don't want to sit there and watch you do that because you flexing on it.
Yeah.
You feel me? So I guess the nigga get mad at Tip. Tip come back to the Tip. Then not only come back to Red Cross, he done called KT. KT, Doug, Mac. Everybody, but I stayed out there with him. You feel me? So, man, listen, he come and get me. The nigga got a dog chain in his head. He got a dog chain. Shout out to him, got 3 feet. We 3 feet. So we all got there. We finna go to a shootout with the nigga. The nigga wanted with Tip. I'm finna pull up on y'all, boy. Yeah, man, woo woo, it's that, man. Shout out.
So wait, hold on. I want to get the story out, Pat. So he got out, flexed on him.
Flexed on him.
Shout out, started topping that shit. Tip said, fuck, nigga, stay right here. I'm gonna be right back.
No, they live in the apartment together. We just moved out here. We don't know these niggas. Like, we from another side. Shout out to them from out here. So, shout out to pull up out here. They swerve. You know, we swerve. You swerve with it. You swerve and get your issue swerving, though. You feel what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to swerve. They come in the apartment. You know, it's the nigga in the back room. They watching. They ain't inched up. You feel me? They ain't mounted. They looking at shout out. Shout out going, go on, bean. You feel me? We got to cut. The pipe dicks ain't out the side. You feel me? We on them. You feel me? So shout out to flex on him. Getting in the back. He parked like, yeah, man, I just got them flex on the nigga at the KFC. Woo, 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 woo. However they get into it. You feel me? Tip, but I'm had a whole apartment on you. You feel me? So we get out there. He come and get me. Hey, one. Hey, man, come down here with us. I come out the door. I ain't got no shirt on. You know, I already been shot before. You feel me? I'm with it. Scars all on me. I got a pair of Tommy Trunks on with the motherfucker. Classic Reebok motherfucker. With the little Jesus piece on with the little mirror motherfucker. You feel me? I got, we go down in the back. So, shit. I think my punch started letting out. We looking at the boy. The boy looked like they come out the gold gym. That what it was. The boy come off around the corner. I was like, Tip, you want to fight these niggas? He come on around the corner like this. I was like, oh, no, man. Pull out, bro. Pull out. Pull out. We pull out. Boom, 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 boom. I end up going up under the gun. I don't know how I do it. I don't know how I meet Michigan shot in here. I end up going right up under the gun. Up on the shot, he ended up dumping the gun out there and throwing the gun. And then he ended up dumping that over, he ended up running back around the building. I said, man, then my mama, we ran back up to my mama in the back door, like, y'all made that motherfucker come here. You feel me? So she tell her to go back. I'm like, mama, you can't turn all us around. We finna go to jail. 12 out here, the nigga bust, we busting. Come to find out, we busting that all due to police, you feel me? Them niggas was selling dope. They got busted too, though. Them niggas was selling dope. They were hot, you feel me? Everybody was high, but you know, Tip, right? Tip used to come and get us into some shit, bro.
Hey, man, that, you know what I think is fucking.
He said, you want to fight them? Look. Hell no. Pull out.
This is how you know that this nigga is a hood. Who the fuck remember what they had on? Yeah. That nigga got in full detail. Now he had some Rap Lauren pants on, nigga.
Tommy Box.
Some Reebok size
we
of
had to stop wearing
Tommy Box is 34, 32.
It was the last of the Mohegan. We stopped volunteering home in high school because he had and did the little. He don't like black people. She was like, what? We just went to burn town. I can't burn all this shit. That's too much of this shit. You can burn yours. I'm going to keep these motherfuckers. I can wear these in the house. They got to wear them outside.
He'll figure it's all right, but I can't rock with you, nigga. You don't fuck with that.
Yeah, see, when I went strictly Ralph, and niggas was like, I had already been wearing the Ralph Michaels.
We got to talk about that shit. You went crazy with the Ralph.
Ralph game is retarded.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I've been fucking with home for years, man. This Ralph, man, nigga don't know this $1,200 jogging suit, man. But, you know, do you know the folk just now fucking with me, man? But these cases I got won't let them fuck with me.
Damn.
You know what I mean? But, you know, they fucking with me a little bit. You know, we're going to go in Lenox on Christmas. And, you know, if you bring your old polo in, I'll give you a new polo. That's for my youth. That's my little young.
What's the name of your foundation?
Heart for the kids.
That was up, because I definitely got a couple of them bitches.
Yeah, man.
I got to bring back.
Yeah, you bring, but you them pieces, you got them pieces on. I got some pieces at home, but I don't play by the mirror. I tell my brother, you can have anything I got. You can have Louis, Gucci, whatever. Don't put it on that record. I be tucking it in, bro. You feel me? Mm-hmm. I be tucking it in, bro. You don't like tucking it in.
You got some cold shit.
It's a certain way you got to wear that Ralph, man, to bring it out, to make Ralph his Ralph.
Yeah, I be posing for that motherfucker. The other night, I was posing for that motherfucker. Had that real Moscow shit on, man. Them folk don't be fucking with that pee. I be shaking the pee on the folk, the real polo. You feel what I'm saying? I ain't bullshit. I be knowing I'm fresh in everybody, too. I'm like, don't come here thinking you're fresh. I don't know who the fuck told you that. You feel what I'm saying?
Joe. I gotta ask you about this shit because you changed the game. You changed the game a bunch of times when you dropped these motherfucking songs. But nigga, my girl got a girlfriend.
I was hanging with Tilt, man.
Nigga, that's my motherfucking daddy song. Nigga.
My girl got a girlfriend.
My girl got a girlfriend. Nigga done made a R&B, four or five R&B versions of this.
My girl, you got a girlfriend.
They go with like that was an anthem, like you know. But you know, we were living that shit. Like we episode with my homeboy back then, back before Shadow was married, was equivalent to spring break in Cancun.
Every day.
Every day.
What the hell Cancun in?
Mexico. I don't know. Somewhere, but when spring break over there, it's whatever goes. Whatever goes, like,
I can't be a part of them parties. See, I done had slut parties, but it's on some shit like, hey, bro, I'm going in to her because she with the shit, but you don't want her to flip out. You feel what I'm saying? Nah, you can't be forceful, my nigga.
D.O. him, boy. D.O. him, man. You can piss on D.O. They ain't no R. Kelly. You feel me?
What the fuck?
You ain't got to have R. Kelly in the mind for D.O. You can piss on D.O. and we have a real life. You feel me? Hey man, we on Star Island with this shit. Like, for real.
I could do that shit. That shit would be just look. I'd just be like a candy with a baby. Hey, go away, man. Look. That bitch in there, the pretty hoe, the one you thought you were gonna marry. I got mouth. Beat on that bitch, man.
Nah, the pretty one you can piss her mouth, what my boy. Nah, for real, nigga. Hey, man. Bad ass hoe, bro. Bad ass bitch, man. The bitch you like the best, bro. She'll fuck a Great Dane, you did.
What the fuck, bro?
Y'all for real. Hey, you better have it. Hey, we at one of them Big Me's parties, bro. You telling? I just said it. Talk I'm telling. Listen,
nigga,
bro.
This is a fucking great Dane. We don't have no questions,
bitch,
bro.
Bitch, fuck a Great
Dane.
We
here to talk to you, my nigga.
About this player shit, man.
Talk to him.
Fuck a dog, man. You understand me? Y'all for real, man. You hold that shit, man.
What kind of dog them fuck?
A Great Dane, motherfucker, man.
Hold up, we got a fan question.
His name Gary.
What is it? Let me see.
Nicole.
He said, she said, do them junkies still stay with your mama?
Yep.
You know, that's one of the coldest lines in the fucking rap.
I went over there. I went to my mama. I seen my brother over there. Them junkies still in there. Hey, tell me, they still in there.
Don't nobody stay with my mama.
Your brother
listen, bro, you just don't feel me. Like, I ain't, I'm just a good rapper, bro. I didn't do all that, make all that money to be changing and be acting crazy and flipping out and doing all that dumbass shit, you feel me? And not in tune. Like, yeah, them folks still around. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah. Hey, yeah, put some thaddies on some shit.
Yeah, I put some thaddies up on the son. You feel me? Man? And take son to church with it. You feel me? But when I tell you, bro, that shit didn't get to me like that. Like, you know what I mean? But you know what I used to do when I used to have that money? I used to call the bank every day, man. How much is in there, motherfucker? Folks said, Mr. Hart, you just called. I know it, man. I just took something out. I just need to know what's in there.
Yeah, gotta make sure it's in there, because the phone will say something else.
Tell me what's on in there. The phone, that motherfucker told me one day, man, you in the negative. I'm like, I'm in the negative. I broke my card. Like I swiped the brown off my card, man.
The strip.
You hear me? What I'm saying? No fuck. Say you swiped the strip out of the strip gone, my boy. You feel me? I gave him my son. I don't need him motherfucker no more. I turned the ATM to a little club right there on campus, man. That motherfucker made me draw the ATM, man. He got it. You feel me? You know, sitting places, just spending money. That shit really don't matter nothing, but I gave that motherfucker back right there. I'd rather go to the bank.
Real talk. That was, I had to cut up my card.
Yeah.
I said, nope.
That motherfucker, but you cut, you know, even if you ain't got cash when you got that card, it's done you.
Yeah, but see, that's who the podcast for, niggas who don't have no card.
Yeah, I ain't got none.
You got a rush card, and the shit go out, and you be like, see, I'm
glad I got a bankroll on me. When that motherfucker run out, that's it, goddamn it. Unless you just bad ahead, and you making me buy red bottles on a day-to-day basis, baby.
How important is that shit?
What?
To buy your bitch red bottoms.
I mean, because
you know, we got niggas who listen to this shit.
Boy, let me tell you something about a player, man.
Give them some Young Dro gang. We got some young niggas listening.
Don't think your old lady stupid. You feel me? Especially if you're a good looking nigga like I am. You know, if you think you're the only bitch got my number, you got to be motherfucking fooling me. You feel me? You're not the only one like this beautiful face, my baby.
Talk to you him,
bro. You gotta know that. And I flirt with whoever I want to, like, but I do have respect for my relationship, but at the same time, I'm not spoken for. You feel what I'm saying? And I don't respect, you feel me? If you really like that bitch, man, marry that bitch, man. You feel me? You put a ring on it, man. Don't keep running around and talking about that bitch, man. You feel me? That bitch, I'm going to suck my pot in them dick. You understand me? You know what I'm saying? So if you like that bitch like that, speak for that bitch. Go and marry that bitch so you can keep that bitch out the street. Cause anything crossing the street over 18, they liable to get hit by 18 wheeler.
Talk.
You feel what I'm saying? I ain't bullshit.
Nah, that real talk. Better put a ring. That's the only time a nigga got respect if it's a ring.
That one I respect a nigga calling my phone with a hoe. Yeah, you married that one. But I don't really get
it. You married that one.
I don't fuck with married hoes. You feel me? Yeah. I don't do that. You feel me? You married.
Let them go.
You married.
But if they do want that, you going to hell.
They want, I don't know, want something. You feel me?
What you mean? You ain't going to hell?
Yes, you am fucking that married, man. She is. You get the fucking the married hoe, knowing that hoe married. Now, she tricked you.
She the one lied to God. You didn't?
Yeah, no.
She went to the office anybody and said,
listen, man, that girl can try to lure you in, man. You got to be with, that's a choice you going to make. You and this hoe going to burn together, my boy. This is a double motherfucking thing, man. She ain't fucking nothing without that dick. You feel me?
Nah, real talk.
Talk to him, Dro.
Immediately, listen, if you had to go to hell immediately, you feel me?
And right then.
Man, y'all going together. You just going to disappear off your dick. This all right, you going to disappear off your dick. Whatever, go on that way to hell immediately. No, both y'all going. Goddamn, you going to be with her. I'm a fucking the Lord. What you would do? I'll fuck this bitch right here. You shouldn't have been fucking her.
It's the 85 South Show. We in here today with Young Dro.
I'm sorry, man.
My nigga DC Youngfly.
I'm fucking that bitch, man.
I ain't fucking that hoe, bro. I know that hoe married. That's just, you
what
know that man.
Tell you look, afterwards, though?
You know that husband got the right to kill your ass and get off now.
Yes, sir.
You hear me? That nigga go insane. That man go insane for a couple of minutes, and the judge gonna grant him that. You feel me?
No, real talk.
Yeah, so real talk. Real look shit. At it. But studies show that in the law book. The law book, when they read them statements out, they be saying this versus the this nigga got off, man. Temporary.
It's a crime of passion.
Called the love. The love right. That what you ask God to give that covenant. You feel me? Like, hey man, don't let them come in between this bond. And here come this man sticking that wood in my woman. I went goddamn crazy.
So how come on Fatal Attraction when them nigga be killing them nigga, they still get 25 lives?
No, they get 25 lives because it be a motive there. Sometimes, you know what I'm saying? Some of these hoes will push you to do it. But you can't do it. You feel me? You got to go on and divorce that woman and drop that woman and let that woman see. You people be trying to put up with the shit. You feel me? When you be living a fucked up marriage. You just trying to put up with it, man. It's time to go, bro. This shit not working. You feel me? Now
you need a good relationship.
Now you fucking another hoe. I'm the worst at it. That's all. I just know.
See, now I got to let my girl go. Okay, we get married and I do some fuck shit. She gonna pop my ass and get off. I can't do that.
That what I'm trying to
say. No, Joe, you was dropping some real game right there.
I ain't know that.
She can't premeditatively do nothing to you.
Oh, okay. Well, I ain't know a nigga can really pop a nigga.
If I catch you in the moment by fucking my woman, you feel me? Who, you feel me? When I pull up on you, bro, and you hit my woman, and I blank the fuck out,
all right, I'm granted. Let me ask you this for the niggas who listen to this show. Fly was telling the story one time about how when he got stabbed, the women was treating him different. I want to ask you as a nigga who didn't, who did not had it, and a nigga who done had it. How different is it? How do women treat you different?
Oh, you want to hear some
between
crazy shit?
When you don't have it and when you do have it.
Was that real bitch that clean your shit back?
No, listen, bro. I been had them hoes, bro.
Right.
That shit ain't trying. That shit made it worse, but.
That's what
I had. Every hoe at there. No cap. I had seagulls at the top, man. Ralph down every day. Ways at the top. Wait, bitch, how much more you want?
Yeah.
I said, nicks and shit. I got one of them bankrolls on me. But I had went to school one day with a $600 over one, brown one, food stamp one. I was having real, man. Come on, just hang with the nigga. The nigga give me the ones out of dope, man. I really ain't selling them. My finesse game off. It's the up the park. I got young hoes taking care of me. You feel me? Man, come on, man. We went doing, we didn't have jobs. Them hoes getting up, whatever, bro. In contact wasn't even. Like, that was just some bonus shit, nigga. We had them all doing that shit in the summertime, boy. Big head, fat hoe, fat hoe. Boy, you finna play like you way big, dog. Don't even trip. And we ain't hitting nothing. The fuck you mean? Head.
Big girl got the head.
Boy, she just paying. You feel me? Home, man. I'm not fucking home.
I hate the big girl. I hate to say it
anymore. Some nigga went in. Some nigga took one for a team. Well, but them nigga was straight. Whoever was him, big up. Bottom boy, like Lil Willie used to be him, big talk to him, big Tasha. Listen, Lil Willie used to fuck big Tasha.
Some hood ass.
Lil Willie used to fuck big Tasha. That young nigga had feelers on every day of the week, brand new.
Yeah, how you live.
But that nigga had to pick the rip, had to pick that hat, that bitch chin too now. Don't get it wrong now. That nigga had to get that hat, that bitch chin. Come on up here and get this shot in my face, baby. Yeah, mustard collard green smelling that bitch. You got, This bitch follow to in the cabin. That whole thing like this. That would get kicked the gang like this. Y'all better get out of my motherfucking house.
That nigga crazy.
That nigga, that was $600. Fuck, man. You feel me? Nigga been prostitute pimping. You feel what I'm saying?
Real talk, man.
Yeah, man. You got
teacher,
paid.
I'm glad I ain't the only one up here talking to prostitute pimping.
Prostitute pimping, man. $5
man, this
pump.
Is the 85 South Show, man. This is a podcast for niggas who smoke a black and mouth.
This is
Bankhead Podcast. This is Bankhead
Podcast today, man.
Shout out to Wayfield.
Real BP motherfucker. Bankhead Podcast.
Shout out the whole Bankhead.
Real Amoco, nigga.
Yeah, man. Sheryl Street. L3 is shit. Rachel Walsh shit. You feel what I'm saying? Everybody, shout out to everybody who go to Huns over there, our Bankhead. You know what I'm saying? Me. All the people that go to Ken by Born Home. You know, Ken's still doing his thing, though.
Ken's still doing it.
Hey,
my friend.
Now, man.
Ken
is embedded into the family of Born. Listen, man.
If you fuck with Ken, I promise you a nigga from Bankhead gonna do your ass.
Yeah, man.
It gonna be a nigga gonna be like,
that one Chinese you can't match with, bro. You feel me?
Real talk.
He will have you fucked up long time.
Long time.
Yes, long time. Long time.
And everybody here friend. And let me tell you, then when I knew this shit,
that man
real,
got the big lemon pepper wing on that side of town, my
nigga,
boy.
The nigga got a big ass stove, but ain't no candy.
Yeah.
In the main part, it's behind the counter. Yeah, it's the boxes out there, though. We let you know what he got. But you ain't even be stealing shit. Oh, shit, bro. You know they got the tie shot right there before you get the cruise.
They got the sock, man.
Okay.
Too.
Nah, okay. But the tie shot right there before you get the cruise.
Yeah.
Okay. No, you done went down. Okay, now this super value right here. Uh-huh. You got cruise right here, but you got the tie shop on this side.
Okay.
Okay, the nigga who, you know where the little barbershop is right there? Nigga, you sell fruit right there and shit, like oranges and tomato, muscadine.
Yeah.
Made my lip burn.
They used to be down there by Bankhead Seafood, too.
Okay, now this is a real West Side. I bet. I gotta kill a nigga right here. Yeah. Okay, before Avalon Apartment was right there, what was right there before Avalon Apartment?
I don't know.
What? You know, nigga.
I don't.
Go back. Before Avalon Apartments, man. And when I said, you're gonna be like,
I don't know.
That athlete foot one right there. No, none of that bullshit. Right there with Avalon apartment. What was right there before Avalon apartment? In the middle of the hood. You can't believe it's sitting right here. You know. Man, you make me mad.
I don't know, bro.
You make right before Avalon apartments?
Take it back to 01. I was so high in 01, bro. Nigga. Yeah, you just go ahead. When you say it, I'm gonna be. I done hung it.
The trailer park, man.
The trailer park was like that.
Thank you, man.
We didn't never get to see the trailer park people, though.
We didn't know nobody
who lived
there. Nigga, it like niggas flew to the trailer park. I'm so glad that shit
made that look really country, bro.
Trailer park sitting right here in the middle of Bankhead, bro. And it like, you don't know who living in that motherfucker. You just see niggas go in and out, that's it.
Yeah, it wasn't even nobody hustled over there. That's why I don't remember it. Like, everything else.
You remember because you had a customer. He said the trailer park was just right in the middle. Me and Winner sat right there
by Duke Flame for 100 years.
Bankhead. We used to walk to the welfare
from Bankhead.
They got the smartest
jays.
By A&P was on Bankhead.
Nigga, all them little cuts them Jays got on Bankhead.
Bro, you remember the barbecue, the chicken out there? Damn, where they sold it on Buffalo Wings that on the top right there on Bankhead. What was that?
What one?
That was.
Not Boss Vinsbury.
No.
Talking about
J.R.
Creek.
J.R. Creek, bro. You remember that?
Come on, man. I'm a West Side nigga, man.
They sell out the bottom of the room. They serve sacks out there, motherfucker.
Nigga, they had the best Pac-Man game in that bitch.
Yeah, bro. It's a good 25 cent game.
This is your West Side
you
history.
You see it now, look. When the bounce over, you feel me?
I don't know about that bounce, then it turned into a church, man.
They was over there. I seen them. They got
talking that shit, nigga.
They got the crib tree up, bro.
We're going to have to.
The bounce look lit now that we
big. Don't it look lit?
But we used to be some young nigga. That motherfucker used to be lit. But juvenile, I don't come through there. I mean, one time, me, Monica, and Rocco went in there one night. Well, I supposed to win. I got wasted. And I think I threw up. Fell out of some shit. ball was hanging out and everything. And I knew,
fucked
up. Bro. I was like, yeah, bro. I'm glad. And who the fuck put these shorts on me? I didn't even know how I got dressed that night.
Now tell them about the motherfucker iron skillet, man. You go to the iron skillet and really eat, bro. Really have a feast, man.
That motherfucker was like, you know how, Golden Corral.
Golden Corral, you really going there and have a truck stop in the hood.
It's a truck stop, though.
It's our Golden Corral, though. We're going there and eat, my nigga.
Iron skillet right across the street.
It's an old lady from Barnholm working there, motherfucker. It's an old lady.
Good in the motherfucker. Everything, homie.
You know, but it's really a truck stop spot. Really, we up here just robbing everything we can. But, you know, them folks used to be spinning. You feel me? Them truck stop folk. That's how nigga from the West Side really just was on like that. You feel me? Like that's how Barnholm made a lot of money. That damn truck stop shit. Nigga was on Bankhead. Well, we used to do a lot of stuff, man. I mean,
where you going, Bubba? How much you need? But yeah, going to Alabama. Boy, I got three of them things.
I remember nigga raped my little cousin. When he raped my little cousin, then when my big cousin, her mama found out, he shot her 6 times. But then he ran down there in Dogwood and tried to wait it out with 12. I was on the news that day, boy. You know, my album had just came out. I'm on the news. I'm like, boy, when he come out down there, boy, I was about ready to do something so I can meet him at pretrial. We were going to kill him. That thing don't kill themselves. You just heard 2 shots in the, you know what I'm saying? They had chasing down the Dogwood apartment. You just heard 2 shots. Bah, bah. We were like, well, you better have him. You feel me? That's what we left. We everybody left after that. We were like, boy, you better have him. Cause, boy, we wasn't even gonna let him get by in 12 car. Damn. You feel me? We wasn't finna let that nigga get by shot, Toya. Shit, Toya. She was the last person to live in Bankhead Court. You hear me? We really were Bankhead. My grandma stayed 37 years. You feel me? We were from the real bricks, you know what I mean? And when that nigga did something to, like, that was like the aunt, one of the aunties, you know what I mean? I mean, fuck, though. We waiting
on that nigga. They
don't know nothing about that, man. We waiting on that nigga, boy.
Real talk.
My mama still in Bankhead right now.
Miss Bankhead?
Yeah, nigga. They used to have pageants out there in Bankhead. My mama still in Bankhead. The male used to live with my grandma out there when the rats was out there real bad. And the mayor, Maynard Jackson Kane, it Maynard Court, but it Bankhead Court, you feel me?
Right.
The man came out there, lived with my mama, when she was like 14, 13, you feel me?
Man, he was the man and shit.
He was the mayor back then, you know what I mean? I wasn't born, but you know, I was able to see my mama on Eyes on the Prize. It's a blockbuster movie. You can go look at it. It's called Eyes on the Prize. Maynard Jackson come to Bankhead Court about the rat infestation, and he just picked our house. You know what I'm saying? Damn. The one I grew up to.
That's some real history,
Bankhead,
right?
We
there.
Real Bankhead to death. You feel me? Back in the day, real West Side nigga. You feel me? So shit, that what we were born at. You know, but my family from Florida though. You know what I mean? My mama though.
What part?
On Temple.
Shout out to Temple.
Tampa is in the motherfucking building, man.
Dade County, man.
I almost got locked up in Dade County, man. Yeah. Right in front of the police on the dirt bike.
Dumb
man.
That shit was funny.
The street long as fuck, man. I'm like, yeah, like, man, ain't no goddamn street, man. I'm looking for a motherfucking street. I said, fuck this shit, nigga.
That shit was on.
I said, got out that motherfucker. I said, fuck this shit. I ain't going to jail in Dade County. Yeah. That shit was crazy, boy.
What's the name of the new project, man?
Oh, man. The new project is I just got my record label called Sauce Music Group. You know what I mean? SMG. I got a new R&B group. I'm developing artists as matter of fact, because these niggas don't know how to do it.
We need to focus these niggas, right
these niggas, but you know, some all these niggas be talented. But when you put these niggas out on the stage that they have
they
to work.
They don't know how to perform. You got to. That's why I pray to make
niggas
perfect.
On interviews. These niggas like, this. Hey, yeah, I had told Shotty. I had one this side there. I had said, shit, everybody like my shit, so they be bumping my shit where I stay for. I killed somebody and they fucked me, shit. I just killed about 10 niggas. I got shot one time, 10 times on top of one, so it made it two. So, what's up? Like, don't do that, bro. You could be front of the hood, but it's books over that motherfucker. Like, proper English in that mother. That nigga should be doing life. He murdered the English language. This nigga should be doing life. He just killed the English language. Like, he skipped all over that shit. But it's cool to I fuck with it. You feel me? I know I'm talking like, hey, shout, look, my boy. This is how we gonna work, you know what I'm saying? But when somebody trying to give you some money.
How you talk when they give you some money?
Sir. First of all, sir, I would like to volunteer this cabinet. What you talking about? Like,
for real, hey, nigga become cabinet. Hey, I want to volunteer this cabinet.
I want to volunteer this cap. You feel me? But you can't.
You fuck with any of the new music?
Hell yeah. We you know, nigga don't know what thug come from, though. You feel me?
They don't know he come from the slum.
Not know that, boy.
They don't know he come from John Burr South.
Can you speak on it? Somebody that really knows.
I went to school with him. They don't know he came from the slum.
This young nigga stood in Crucial. You feel me? It's a shootout here every day when you play, when you trip. My same spot. I ain't moving. Fuck with me, Dro. I go get. You know, I used to go get home, pick home up. And ride, boy. No deal. Listen, bro. We used to be out with. I used to call the man 3-4 in the morning, man. John and find him, man. Up. Hey, man. The man, mama saw me the other day. I'm like, man, y'all motherfuckers still kick that shit. I said, I ain't talked to the bouncer since he got on. Right. Look, but you know what I mean? Even though today, even when I see y'all today, it's still the same shit. But that young nigga, man, will fight. Listen, we in the West End one time. I see home. They gun playing. Hey man, that man about his business, man. Don't play no game with that young nigga like that. Like, talking that crazy. Ain't need to talk crazy when the nigga get money, but all that cap shit, man, I don't gonna see about your ass, man. I don't nasty like that. You feel me? That young nigga nasty. You feel me? When he come out in the street, shit, that young nigga real nasty. Shoot you in the face, nasty. You feel me? That shit in the South, Cleveland, from Jonesboro South to North, I used to pull up in Ashton Martin by myself. You feel me? This how I kick it. I know him from back then. Little nigga, keep telling niggas fuck with him. You feel me? I go get him one day. We do a song called One Thing About Me, you know, on Ralph Lauren Reefer. This was 7 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
I was the first nigga, hey, you might want to see this nigga. Rocco, you might want to see the nigga. Rocco said, but I fuck with him.
You know they always going to say that.
Listen, bro, man. I fuck with him now, bro. Listen, bro, you got to go. I be having shot in the car with me. You feel me? We be on Bleeding, you know. We be kicking it, man. Round, man. geeked out our shoe. I'm running around bare feet, man. We having our way, man. We in the studio, bare feet.
Bare feet. See, it's West Side shit. See, West Side thank you, man. Talk that shit.
Real comfortable. You feel me? We just be comfortable, like, you know what I'm saying? Ain't no cap. You know what I mean? Nigga ain't on some real shit, but I'm real as a motherfucker. And I like the new music coming. I like Lil Uzi. But you know, having the verses and then I hear nigga trying to always shout me out from the Drake.
Right. That's what I was gonna ask you, because a lot of the young niggas 30. Fuck with you. And then, you know, like a lot of these people interview motherfuckers and they set the question to be fucked up to make it sound like, hey, man, what you think about the new artist? Like, they'll never say, well, who you fuck with? They always want to go for the negative aspect of the shit.
They little, you know, they call it different kind of rap. But, you know, each his own, you know, that's a craft. You know, whatever you spit out your mouth, I think that you took the time to perfect that in your way to do that. You know, in your way, I don't think you should be knocked for that at all. You know, just because I rap different. You know what I'm saying?
Right. You a superstar in your own right. Is there anybody that you want to work with that you haven't got the chance to?
DC.
DC.
Besides DC. No, you own flat too.
I want to work with Kanye. That's one nigga I really want
to work with. Out the rehab, Kanye?
I want to work with Kanye. Out the rehab, in the rehab, just because, you know, I cried out some shout of music before, you know, and I really dedicated some of that stuff to my mama, you know, for some of the time we done been through.
Right.
And seeing my mama pull through, you know, from being shy 5 times to, you know, going, to, you know, when she didn't graduate from school when we were young, I watched her go back, get that diploma, you know what I mean, and that just was something strong to me, you know what I'm saying? And by herself, you know what I'm saying? And after she, you know, and we just...
You say your mom got shot 5 times?
Yeah, at 731 on Camilton.
Damn.
Yeah. They shot her all up under the car. But, you know, and when Kanye came out, I couldn't find the words to, you know, give to my mama. You feel what I'm saying? So I did it through shouting, and I gave it to her. She cried like a mother. Like, I like, this how I feel. You feel what I'm saying? Mom. And it's called Hey Mama from Kanye. So, hell yeah.
Real talk.
Yeah, I want to folk shout her.
Anybody else?
I really did a lot of stuff with a lot of people, you know. Well, Taylor Swift.
You fuck with Taylor Swift? Yeah. You fuck with Taylor Swift?
I think everybody
we love Taylor Swift.
I went into Bruno Mars, you know, Taylor
Bruno
Swift.
Bruno going in.
I want to do something with The Weeknd.
You fuck up with
the hook. He like the Kirk Franklin hip hop.
Yeah, but you know what though?
You said The Weeknd.
You really won't get hood and that type of shit. So I think that'll be
the reason why.
That's good stuff to do. Like go to here, what you know what I'm saying, to there. You know,
Super
and I think that they would do good down here too, because I grew up off of, you know, that kind of music. You know, U2, Google Dolls, and.
Weekend sound back, like nickel crying with his goddamn.
You know what I mean? Gonna cross over there?
Weekend be crying.
I want to. You know what I mean? But it's just too far.
I feel like
out.
All this shit that you name it, you'll fuck that shit up.
I did come up.
Salmonella, vanilla, how the school shoot. I'm like, I don't know what the fuck he said. But that shit
that nigga
crazy.
Said, shoot him in the guts and the nuts and the liver.
Nigga went crazy.
Leaving with ducks in the river, man.
Fucking right. Going off on some shit, man.
I was stimulated. You feel me? Like, I don't write no more though.
You just go off the top.
I just do it. I might grab the pen. If I grab the pen, it's a serious beat.
Yeah, but, you got to make sure you go crazy.
But most of the time, you don't take much.
So I can do that. You go off the top.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this: where are you musically right now?
Well,
what you feeling? What your vibe at?
It's still in the streets. I really can't tell you that it's changed a lot, but I think that I've seen some different stuff. You know, I seen a man transform this year. That was, you know what I mean? And I'm speaking on my own, but the nigga spoke it. I seen something happen with a person that was totally fucked up. You feel what I'm saying? Like,
God damn, I thought you were going good with it.
What happened, man?
Let the streets know.
I mean, shit went cool, bro. I mean, you don't do that, bro. You don't do that. You know what I mean? Like, you know, this me, you know. This me, this my body, you know what I mean? This my body, this is my instruments on this body. Where I carry this body at, I know what's up, you feel me? this mine, you know what I mean? This me. So if you try to take something from me, I'll buck on that. You feel what I'm saying? I ain't gonna let you do that. You know, if the police came, you know what I'm saying, this mine. You know what I mean? You going to jail, I go to jail. This me. You feel me? That's the same way I feel about your gun, your car, your girl. You feel what I'm saying? It's your house. You feel me? That's yours. These are your things. You feel me? I can't. My pistol don't shoot for you. Your pistol don't shoot for me. You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
If you pull that motherfucker out right now and roll these niggas in here, that's your bread. You feel what I'm saying? You know what I mean? The cops come, that's your pistol, my boy. You know what I mean? Don't think that these niggas in here gonna be wanting to take your charge. Like, and you don't even really know niggas like that. You know what I'm saying? We just know you on some music shit, nigga. I don't know you from the street. You ain't no street nigga to me. You didn't come up in Kimberly. I ain't see you in Perron, bro. I ain't see you in Bankhead. I don't know your history. I don't know your name. Like, you know, we went to jail, they revealed your name. You feel what I'm saying? Jonathan, bro, you feel me? I know your name now. But, you know, you been knew who I was. So the pistol shit, when they pulled up, bro, like, you know, that when the man come in, bro, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, my tool, you know what I'm saying? You real niggas do that, nigga. A whole ass nigga can't do that. You feel what I'm saying? He on some slime shit. Feel me? Hey, I'm finna get another nigga to take charge. Another nigga take the charge. My boy, wait a minute. We don't even know you. Who is you telling to take a pistol charge? What for what? That's yours. You feel me? That motherfucker was in your nutsack, my boy. That's your gun. Well, however you take it, so we get on. We going down by the pistol. Cause, you know, I ain't finna be saying, hey, bro, it hit pistol.
You gonna see about that intake. Me and you gonna talk.
We talk? You feel me? But I done kept it so real. I'm in jail with you keeping it real. You feel me? You know how real I'm here? Hey, so I'm in there like, so, bro, what you want? What else you want? You feel me? He, oh, bro, I don't know. I said, bro, what else you want? I'm in jail with you, bro. I got four show, like you did. I got a 60-piece to pick up. You feel me? What's going on, my boy? Oh, man, I think one of your homeboys going, one of my homeboys? Boy, you tripping, bro. You know what I mean? Them folk put us in the same room and everything, man. We in our banking. I'm ready. So the shit clicking. I'm going to catch a fade with home in a minute. You feel me? Because we waiting on you. You know, they want to know who the pistol is. But we know you to tell 12 who your pistol this is, bro. You feel me? So you taking your time, I come out the room. Oh, man, I know what's going to go on. This what's going to go on, my boy. Since I'm going to do it right, bro. Listen, give me what mine. You're going to take what there, and you're going to take what's yours, my boy. If they want to state me, all they're going to say exactly what we finna do. You feel me? Hey, man, look, man. I know what's going on. Y'all locked all us up for the same thing. It ain't all out, my boy. They're mine. You feel me? That's how they finna go now. We already, hey, you good, ain't it, my boy? Yeah. All right. He right. He say here. 12 asked him, ain't my pistol, bro. He ain't had. And I'm like, hey, this nigga go right here. Ain't my pistol, bro.
Everybody knew who was going to take it. You know you're going to take it. You knew you're going
to
take it.
It ain't even that. We was nice enough to do that. You feel me? We was nice enough to even say this. You know what I'm saying? Man, we nice enough to even be here, bro. My partner want to hit you in the mouth right now. You feel me? I'm in here stopping home. I'm coming home now. Hey, man, chill, bro. Chill, bro. Look. Hey, the nigga tripping like, I don't give a fuck about home, bro. I'm finna knock home ass out. That's your homeboy. You feel me? I'm like, for real. You know what I'm saying? I go in there and talk to y'all. I mean, you folks ain't with all that shit, bro. I'm not taking no tool. You taking your own trip. Feel me? Then we're going to go on. You finna do that. You finna do that. Y'all finna do that. You feel me? And I told him, nigga, I said, but I don't give a fuck about them running y'all nigga really, cause I'm down here, I'ma burn y'all out. You feel me? I'm really pissed off cause y'all nigga ain't let me get locked up. You feel me? Not Dro, bro. You feel me? No, not shout. I done been in this move before. Hey, look, bro. Yeah, all the niggas took that, I'ma burn all y'all nigga ass out. We gonna be through with this shit in a minute. Ain't nobody without that extra shit, bro. And ain't nobody taking your trip home. We didn't know you like that. Yeah, like that, but I'm paying home to go on the road. You feel me? I'm paying you. You feel me? Come on the road, bro. You doing all that. Man, he talking about, I guess he answered the phone, man. When I see, bro, you locked up. You're not even going through what you got to go through for that. You just locked up for it. Man, when you get out, don't nobody want to hear that shit. Cap ass nigga, you, and I don't want no nigga playing no nigga music while I'm around, nobody doing none of that. I catch home in my vicinity, I can't tell you what's gonna happen. You feel me? You don't just do that. I seen a nigga change, bro. And I saw, I'm asking this man this shit while we behind in the courtroom in cuffs, bro. Like, you really finna ride this out, my nigga? The nigga look at me and turn, bro. Like, nigga, I had no pills. This is shit I know. You feel what I'm saying? Oh, my boy, it's your rocker. You got this motherfucker out. Hey, boy, I have a beat found me. You volunteering this motherfucker everywhere else now. We got here with 12 at in droves just because of who I am. Man, I'm going to headbutt your ass.
It was a lot of y'all had done went down that day,
old nigga down there. We all already know what's going on. Mm-hmm. But I do not choke rockers. I got a nigga with a rocker that I pay the cash to. You feel me? He is security. You feel what I'm saying? These folks cost $500 a goddamn trip, bro. You feel me? We insuring. These folks, I don't need to. You feel me? This home finna draw down on you. He going for the life. You feel me? He paid to do this. What the fuck I need? You know what I mean? I don't do it. Them days over with for me, my boy.
That's the street code. If you in the car, what you got on you,
that's yours.
It's yours.
What you think, 21 here? We went by the code. Boy, you 21? Hey, look, boy, if I get in the car, all y'all nigga 21, ain't it? That mean, bro, that mean you taking your own, you holding your own. Like y'all men in here, bro. These are men. Everybody got their own little prison sentence on them. He got a nick on him. Home got about a 10 on him. He got Drake on him. He got, you know, I got a 15 on him when the motherfucker loaded up with the right thing. You feel me?
Right.
We got our own felonies, bro. What the hell you think, you feel me?
We not sharing.
I don't want no extra felony, but I got life already. You feel me? These folks not letting me out. I don't give a fuck what you say. You not getting out. He not getting out. I'm not getting out. We convicted felon with a 2, bro. Ain't nobody getting out. Feel what I'm saying?
And it ain't mine.
So you can take that bullshit on somewhere about how many children you got and what kind of career. Who the fuck you talking to about a career? You feel me? You better get in line, my boy. I got hits, boy. I got a real catalog. What the fuck you mean? I'm not finna go down about your 2. You got me fucked up, and you got me fucked up for the rest of your life. I can't see you nowhere. You got me fucked up. You feel me? Don't play no game like that. You 12. Home sent the police out of my house looking for another pill. So I'm like, I asked him, I said, bro, you sending 12 to my house?
All this shit gonna get out.
Yeah, all this shit out, but hey. Damn. I mean, listen here, man. I don't care about it. I ain't get what. You make good music. Mm-hmm. But you're a duck. And you belong in the pun.
You sound like Dro, for real.
Because
you know niggas from the street, you know what I'm saying?
I took a nigga over for, you feel me, fucked her. You know what I mean? It couldn't have been that because I was a player. You going to expect that. You know what I mean? Don't leave your girl around me.
True player for real. That's my nigga.
STIP. You did. I ain't bullshit. Leave no hoe around me until I fought Joe. The first time I heard him say that, I said, okay, now, fuck you, bitch. You see, the little hoe that I already keep, you know what I'm saying, swung around. I had in there riding, and we went up through that Buckhead way. You feel me?
Dang.
I mean, I gave it a little.
Damn, that's crazy.
Shout out to Orlando Brown.
Cause like,
I beef with Orlando.
No, I ain't beef with no. One thing, nigga, I'm a real nigga.
That shit don't go far.
No, they don't. But that shit crazy because when I listen to his music, bro, like I actually fought with him. You know, you feel what I'm saying? Like fought with him. You feel what I'm saying? But when that story went down and when that situation went down, it was awesome. Now who lied?
Yeah, because listen, he came at to the end. He said, "I'm gonna take my pills, shot. I'm gonna take it." Like, I ain't gonna let you go down. Like, he was like,
y'all was at school.
Listen, bro. Then he told me, he was like, well, I can't sleep. if I do that, I'm thinking to myself, how the hell you sleeping? Because you done did it, because the 12 had come back and told up from the jump. From the jump, sir, it was yours. This what this guy said. You feel me? From the jump, 12, like, the guy already told us that y'all saying his heels. You feel me? Them folk didn't even charge this nigga with the pistol. This nigga lied, said he was in the car with my security. You went in and you was in the car with us, bro. You lying. Damn. We didn't want to tell on you. Then why we locked up, bro. We don't even want to tell on you, bro. You feel me?
You got a nigga back to call like, hell no.
Bro, listen, bro. The man gave us a minute and said, I better get this shit together. Nigga, they cause he called. Let me tell you one thing about me. They couldn't get me out of state. 12 already got these niggas. Feel me? They got the car surrounded outside. I'm not out there. I'm on stage rapping. I'm at a GSU, Georgia Southern. I'm kicking shit on stage. You know, this 12 right there with me. I'm rapping. 12 walked me in there. You feel me? Yeah, 12 walked. They walked me in and with me all the while. So I come out stage. Shout out to man. He got a pistol in the car. Okay, me and you know what's going on with that. So, I mean, I walked outside and said, man, y'all want to talk to me? Really go on in here because this shit embarrassing out here. Y'all got these sent out by the car. The nigga said, y'all heard about Migo? I said, what happened? You know, well, y'all better ask them what happened because we finna whoop man. And they took two. I said, so y'all finna, man, fuck that. Put the cuffs on Dro right now. I'm like, me? I'm looking at like, y'all niggas finna let these folks. I'm looking at my team like, you know, you feel me? My man and me go to jail and everything, but, you know, them supposed to be the real crabs of the situation. Like, well, we not letting it go down. Mm. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah. Out the strength of me, how I fuck with Shouted, they ain't voluntary. You feel me? They ain't really do that shit. Shouted, let's see how this shit play out.
You don't want to see. Like, yeah, who real in the situation?
Let's see how this shit play out. Bro, there ain't nobody point. You feel me? But we all know what's going on. See what? And then, the way home really fucked itself up, I can't really say, but because it's what they're going to have in court. You feel what I'm saying? Like, he played himself, and God, my right-hand witness. You feel what I'm saying? He knows, bro. I can't make this shit up. I went dead lying on a nigga for what? What kind of game would I have lying on you about a damn gun, bro? I don't have nothing to lose or gain from that. That's not $1 million to me. Like, that's not nothing. Like, you're going to get your ass whooped playing. You feel what I'm saying? Somebody gonna whoop your goddamn ass, and you don't know who my cousin is. You don't know who I'm skin to. Like my boy said, man, I'm living every price of me. You're not finna be kicking it 4 seasons. I've been to name them. The West Side, the whole West Side. I've been 4 seasons, some here. PDE, Paradise, I don't give a fuck, the 9. You're not finna be hanging with another motherfucking soul from there without getting 8, bro. You feel me? Don't think nobody with that crazy shit. We're not playing with you, bro. About that, bro. None of that.
That's how a nigga from Atlanta talk for Vogue who see we try to see what the fuck we talking about. Yeah, we bro. Really don't be bullshit.
We really don't, bro. For real, man. And that's the end of that situation. Yep. The roles that we're playing, I take honor in my role. You know, I've done a lot of things to hinder a lot of things that I could have done positively. You know,
hinder.
With the money.
Yeah, you've been hanging around Tip Hinder.
Hinder.
I like to say hinder
me from doing a whole lot of things. So if you are ahead of me, I salute you. I take my hat off to you for being able to be focused with the mindset that we like. Where I come from, like, we weren't accountants. We wasn't good business guys. We wasn't good, you know, we didn't finish school like that. So we really didn't really know that much about how to manage money and keep it and, you know, not be wanted for taxes and, you know, once you find that stuff out, you have to find yourself. And, you know, that's what I've done, you know. I went back and disputed shit with the IRS and, you know, because in a way, shit, man. You know, I didn't ask for that shit. I just got some money, you know what I'm saying? And they were like, yeah, man, but after you got them old $3-4 million, man, you had to turn in a lot of that money. You know, those monies was not turned in, and, you know, those taxes, well, that shit come back and hunt you, bro.
Hey, yeah.
And that shit not no joke. That, you know, when you being like...
Hey, where's the snack?
Hey, you talking about... And I see, but I didn't mind putting the lien on my shit. Like, right. I didn't dispute that. Like, I was like, it's a lot of stuff I don't see, but it's a lot of, I'm free. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, I began to clean that stuff up then with the Heart Foundation and then with the new record label. And then, you know, me and Tip getting back on new pages, which, you know, we just taking artists and, you know, getting packages and deals and, you know what I mean, new movies.
I can't wait to sign up there.
Yeah, man. Shit, I've been shooting Love & Hip Hop for a little while.
Oh, mm-hmm. Shit.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Fuck with Love & Hip Hop. Bring that real shit to Love & Hip Hop. Finally, a real
we been talking all this goddamn time, and you ain't tell us that shit.
God, a lot of things about me you haven't asked. Finally, a real rapper.
Man, me and Flower, we ain't got to ask. We get respect where respect is due. We ain't in no position to ask you shit.
Fuck that script shit, man.
We talking to you.
Now, look, it's like this, bro. They asked me, they were like, you know, what do you want to do? I told them, you know, I ain't going to let y'all write it. You know what I'm saying? Like, because that's some bullshit. You're not finna be talking crazy, throwing no drinks and shit on me. Getting me in the face and wrestling old strippers and shit. I'm not doing all that shit. You fuck around and hit me with that camera on. When that motherfucker off, I catch your ass at church and I'm going to give you a 3-peat. Don't play with me. Like on or off camera, don't play. Like, I don't see how they going to get what they want out of it unless we actually. But I think that them being the number one show in the country or the world, that motherfucker is like, and it's Atlanta too. It's not another show. It's right. Atlanta, and I guess we're trying to fight for that spot. But the shit that they're volunteering on that camera, I don't think that's Atlanta.
Mm-mm. At all,
Joe, you got to be on that. Represent the city, right?
Joe, you got to kick.
Don't
that
be on
shit,
that bitch,
man,
with dirty socks and shit. Man.
I mean, yeah, I'm gonna be on that with dirty socks. Yeah, we just told you about our feet.
You got to kick that real west side. Yeah, hey, Palmer, I don't know who the fuck Hong thought he was talking to.
Who the hell Hong thought he was, homie?
I get fired in it, bitch.
Yeah, you talking about?
Fuck wrong with you?
Listen, bro. I told him for like we might be talking, and I might just say, hey, you talking about? The folk might look at me like.
What he say?
It might be like, "Joe, what's up?" I'm like, "Hey, you talking about what's that?" But it's just how we talk. And right. They'll get lost.
What did he say?
What did he say? He was like, "The hell are you talking
hell
about?"
About where? Like, shut the fuck up.
But it's but you know me and Good Shooter on there. Good Shooter, who you know, Good Shooter, real West Side gambling house. You know, you having paper in the city. You know, Good Shooter. Me and Shotta went to Thero together. You know, Shotta got a little yaki shit. Look, Good Shooter brought me Young Thug and Cash Out before they came out. You feel what I'm saying? Good Shooter, real talk. Like, walked them up in there. Them young niggas were arguing. You know, they was in there. But I ain't shouting, man. You feel me? Thug and Cash Out. But you know, Good Shooter.
And they had a dispute about that little song?
Yeah.
Keep going. That shit was so fucking hard, nigga. That was a hard. I think that's the song that blew Thug up.
I'm a keep going.
Man, what? He had a bad bar, bro. He had a bad verse on
that. That one I used to fuck with.
That why? Be like, oh, that nigga going in. Who the fuck did he
get? Listen, bro. Thug used to go in. And, but you know, when Good Shooter brought me them boy a long time ago, Good Shooter was just, you know, Good Shooter was from the White Boy Marco Day, you know, the Bloody Summer. You know, Bloody Summer was, like, my family was in the Bloody Summer. You know what I'm saying? Like, Mo, you know, White Boy, you know, we them Bloody Summer niggas, like, you know
man,
what I'm
this,
saying?
Man, talk to him about the Bloody Summer, man.
Come out here playing.
I got the whole affidavit. Like, I got the whole transcript on that shit. You feel me? Because, you know, my girl writing the book on that shit. You know, my girl, you know, she in the Oprah Book Club and shit like that.
But tell them what the Bloody Summer was.
The Bloody Summer was, like, you know, back in Katrina, when Katrina had came, like, the New Orleans nigga had came up here. And it was just, them boys were hungry. You know, the society had.
06, 07? Yeah,
society had really counted them people out. And them people were coming to Dallas and Atlanta. And them folks were, it was a bloody summer out here. You feel me? We lost
control. I'm not even gonna lie. Am I up or am I off?
You on?
I'm off.
You up?
I can't hear. I'm not even gonna lie, but we had some New Orleans niggas coming, bro. When I say, you thank you, hood. Until you ran into some New Orleans and Florida niggas.
Man,
bro.
Them niggas was
like,
not playing. When
listen,
I saw
man,
a nigga from
these
New Orleans
really,
at Walmart.
But we held our own, though. You know what I'm saying? We thugged down, we shit, down the but shit, like, these niggas on some other
but
shit. Like,
this
how I fuck your mama, like, son. You be like, fuck.
This what I knew. This how I knew them niggas
but
was
but
different.
That shit, but out that whole paperwork, though, was really my fault. You feel what I'm saying? Like, like no joke, like, oh, wow, like really my, like some people I sleep, like my partner who right in the next room type shit, like that my real home, but like, you know what I'm saying, shout out to them, got life and fire, you know, niggas got their time, niggas got 25, niggas got 50, but niggas had real bodies, and you know, the city was fucked up, the city had, see, but the city were turning on each other, you know, the city was tripping, the city, the Atlanta always will let you in, but ain't no telling if you're gonna get out, you feel what I'm saying, like, it's a lot of niggas that came down here and then didn't go back home, bro, you feel me, like, by playing, and it was a bloody summer that summer, because like another city was up on the, you know, some scrutiny or whatever, you know, it wasn't no good look for New Orleans, and it was like they turned their back on them folk, you feel me? FEMA wasn't coming in, like, right, you feel me? You had them calling goddamn FEMA, called the chopper was on Katrina spray, but them folk were up here with them motherfuckers walking around. But listen, it wasn't nothing that you could tell a person that moved up here that didn't have nothing. Yeah. But we up here, like, well, who got it? But they wasn't waiting. But when you and but the city was already, you know, you might catch a nigga mad at somebody. And just, them nigga might whoop up. I'm like, I'm gonna let them nigga eat them nigga. You feel what I'm saying? And that's how that shit was. And them nigga wasn't playing. They were on go. They were really handling our beef that we wanted to handle. You feel what I'm saying? We were gonna handle it anyway. But since y'all out here, yeah, them boy, you know, this shit going on like this. You feel me? We'll let you in. You know, but them nigga was. They paper.
They were about it. They were going, no, to
them
see
nigga,
y'all.
Them nigga call you, bro. Hey, boy, we want to ride like you, Ryan. You better give him some. You feel what I'm saying? Nigga not playing. Nigga not, you know what I'm saying? You having to. You right here having, you ain't getting nobody. Man, you crazy. Bloody summer. And this nigga was legal, but let nigga volunteer that shit. You feel me? Nigga knew what was going on. The city knew what was going on. They were letting that shit happen.
Hey, tell them about the Miami boy. Now, I ain't gonna lie. Some Miami boy handled that business, but a lot of them niggas, we sent them niggas back home.
But listen, bro. I was a young nigga. I was a watch out for them niggas. PC. All them niggas, like, I knew them niggas. Like, them niggas, when them niggas got their time, We was there. You know what I'm saying? We was in courtroom, like, them niggas trying to get up to come for. I'm like, boy, them niggas killing nigga who going for it, boy. You keep running out that time, you telling them shit. Every time somebody go to court and tell, it'll be a shootout. You feel what I'm saying? It'll be somebody get shot up. They killed Dirt, man. They were killing nigga, bro. Them niggas used to tell me, hey, boy, go get the fuck out of my head. Cause shit, I was watching out for $1,000. I was 12. You hear me? $1,000 every Saturday, man. My mom was like, hey, you keep getting money from him. Hey, I watched that bone right there, man. Nigga, $1,000 every week.
You hear me? I would have been on that motherfucker like that, him.
Yeah. I was doing that. But, you know, I stayed in a grown folk, some grown
never folk, blink.
That's how I got shot. Stayed in somebody's grown business. You feel me? Young ass nigga, what you doing to him?
All they know, man, is the young nigga.
Hey, time, man. I know how to cut shot like a woman, though, nigga. I'm finna bitch ass nigga. Your draw smell like goddamn gasoline and mildew. Yeah, but your old lady don't fuck with you because you don't take care of your children. I've been fucking your daughter for 9 months. I'm like, stay, man, who that young nigga? I'm gonna shoot the shit out this nigga, man. Fuck you mean, nigga. Hey, tell my nigga. Who said it? And Rico said it from the west side. Oh, man, that young nigga mouth got me in some trouble, bro. I used to have that smart mouth like that, you know what I mean? Coming from that side, that's why I went in with time to rap. Them niggas were like, that young nigga know it all. You know what I mean? Like Pee-wee know it all. Pee-wee who got the time, who locked up. Pee-wee knew it all. Pee-wee had the game free to go. You feel what I'm saying? Roscoe Pee-wee, man. And then he kicked the game, man. You real feel what I'm saying? You feel me? He kicked shit. Bitch got the hair, man. Bitch need to take this shit like a fish take the water, man. Real pimp shit now. But at the same time, it's some thug shit, too. You know, we ain't just going pimpish. We going thugging. Right. We some player. We really with the jack of all trade in Atlanta, nigga. Atlanta, nigga. You really can't, you know, you don't know which one he working. You feel what I'm saying? Nigga pull up, you don't know, this nigga pimping, selling dope. You feel what I'm saying? Nigga might rake card. Come on, man. Nigga pull up, volunteering all type of caps in the city. A city nigga? Man, nigga sell water to a well, man. A city nigga will.
A city nigga. They don't know about a city nigga.
That's why when nigga come up, nigga got all the game. Down the road, nigga don't like her like that.
You can tell when you got down, when you really spin that game with a nigga. Get that lean back and be like, where you from, y'all?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That is exactly what they do.
Nigga lean.
Cause you just be knowing.
Now, if you a bullshit for Nelson, a nigga lean forward at you and be like, Yeah. Now, where you from, Shaw?
It's a difference.
It's a difference. Nigga, say
you
from. It's
you
a
can,
difference.
You can tell in the way you... What's Shaw? Like, if a nigga pop to you, I'm gonna hear you from.
You feel me? Like, where you from, Shaw? But when you kicking that game, nigga lean back like... Where you from, Shaw? Nigga, you hit.
85 South Show, we in this bitch with Young Dro, man.
Man, most dead.
Trap Tales.
Trap
Tales. What, it's interesting. Dro. I feel like I'm in the trap just smoking like, but they don't know nothing about that shit, Dro.
Man, tell that, man. For real, I come up from John Holt Day, man, with Terry White. You know, Terry White them going to jail. Charles Black them when they were getting raw, they were Tech Wood were pumping. Alpha Mega them were taking his shit. You feel me? I was young nigga.
Talk about that
Peanut,
story, man. Peanut, fuck them, that bullshit.
Peanut them were living. You know,
Alpha Mega story.
Peanut was living back when, you know, Nut who died, you know, I brought really Nut. You know, Alpha Mega used to be right there with Nut them on Army. You know what I'm saying? So I used to be over there, Pink City, you know, greeting them. You should be over there. All them niggas.
That hurt y'all feeling though on the low.
Yeah,
now, I ain't gonna lie, let me tell you one of my street stories, right? One of my little partner, right? Yeah. He was like, hey, pull up, nigga want some Miley. I said, bet. So I go in the crib. And I'm like, yeah, I'm finna get handed to him. He like, nah, he won't, nigga. I look to the right. Yeah, Alpha Mega. I said, hey, bro, let me talk to you. He go outside. He said, what's up? I said, bro, you got all your shit on the table, y'all in there. He and ha-ha. You know who the fuck that is? He said, yeah, nigga, they Alpha Mega. I said, no, nigga. Do you know who the fuck that is? He like, yeah. I said, no, nigga. The nigga who told ya. He like, man, go on. I said, look, I'ma sell him to you. You can sell it to him. You feel what I'm saying?
He didn't have nothing to do with two. Yeah. But the nigga did some stuff like that long time ago. I guess until asked him, did he do it? He was like, well, did you do it? And he was like, well, it was a nigga I ain't know.
So what he's saying is that he lied on the nigga to get the heat off him.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm not calling him a snitch. I was just scared to sell him to my... Yeah, I just felt like if I sold a nigga that mile, I said, that's 10 years, my nigga. I wasn't doing it.
That you know, but you know, I couldn't hold that against bro. Yeah, I see bro. Bro knocked the nigga ass clean out for me one day. We were walking, nigga had felt on my ass. Fiance had touched on the cracks. A white boy. Man, when I tell you, after nigga knocked that man, hit the man in the jaw and split it. It opened. You feel me?
Nah, he a big ass nigga. Now I remember. Nah, I can't even really talk about
it. You said a white boy grabbed your fiance crying.
We was at Stroker. He grabbed the crotch. He was like, yeah, fuck you mean, bro. He looked at me. He was like, shit, did I stutter, nigga? Ain't your bitch. I don't know. I'm looking. But if I could say something, Alpha Mega had him lift this bar off God's greatest earth, boy. I'm talking about homies in the album.
But the crazy part about it, man, I wish everything would have played out with this situation because I know for a fact Alpha Mega can rap like a motherfucker, nigga. On that. Put him in the dirt. But nigga, I used to fast forward. You know, I used to fuck with Tip and Busta Rhymes, Paul. Yeah. But I said, this big motherfucker here talking some real gangsta shit. Put him in the front door, 50 in the back. And I was like, that nigga talking that shit, man.
But he would really see the reason why I came off like that. Home really listen.
That's what
like.
I felt that. Yeah, I remember one time I was on the shitter. I couldn't get that turn out. He was like, 50 at the front, don't 50 in the back. I said, there it is. That's what I want to hear. That's that shit, nigga.
Oh,
shit.
Listen, man, that nigga was a real nigga, though. That nigga used to make people look at me in the face. But, you know, home right over there, you know what? That ass got killed at home. Home used to be hanging right there, too. That's where everybody used to be at, though.
Yeah, a lot of people, like, motherfuckers used to get their haircut and shit, all that little green stove.
Me too.
All that extra shit, you know what I'm saying? Bro. So, it's a lot of real niggas out there, man. Just be misunderstandings, man. I just wish niggas would just do right, man. You feel what I'm saying? Right, it is what it is.
Put these guns down. I swear to God, we need to put these guns down. But I can't tell you if you cross that line, you're going to be safe. You know?
Yeah.
Don't want nobody to put the gun down.
I'm not even going to lie. I'm bringing the fighting days back, bro. Because you remember, like, bro, in the 90s. See, you a little bit older than me. Yeah. Oh,
I'm 36.
Yeah, fuck yeah, you're older than me, nigga.
Say that.
Like, but in the 90s, when we grew up, it's only like, if you was like, say for, you know, back then, niggas used to be hanging together like 20, 30 deep. Maybe two niggas got the pistols because they ain't hearing.
And they revolvers.
And they ain't hearing none of that. They in the back like, y'all nigga fight. If we here for the nigga uncles.
Yeah.
We ain't here none of that. Y'all nigga fight, squab it out, we here. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah, like, nigga, we had to, if you ain't know how to fight, you had to learn how to fight. Mm-hmm. Like, it wasn't no pick up a gun, learn how to do this shit. It was like, nah, nigga, go out there and slap ball. He be like, nah, bro, ain't with that shit. Slap his ass yeah, anyway.
They don't slap your ass out. Like,
slap his ass anyway.
But, you know, nigga, I already practicing, and you put something on the nigga. Like, when I'm coming up, you just knock something off the nigga on in his own. You feel me, nigga? The bad one knocked this out my own. You feel me? But you gonna learn how to
fight. Oh, yeah, I remember that shit. You know what I mean? And nigga grab your hand and slap him, and now he gonna slap you. Like, nigga, he grabbed my hand.
Yeah, he grabbed my hand.
But, what would you say to the young niggas who might be listening to this shit?
I mean,
who think they out there about their life?
I don't condone any wrong. I don't, like, my mama can do something wrong. I cannot stand with her. Because, like, that goes on my report card at the end of, you know, when at the end of my living. I thank God you cannot stand with nobody and they wrong. So, if you have to defend yourself, you know, make sure you're doing it in the right way. You know, I'm not telling you to go out and be a wuss. You know, stand up for yourself. You know, stand your ground.
You got to be a man,
you
man.
You know, be a man about yours. You know, right. If you're going to start some shit, make sure that it's for a legitimate reason, for your, you know, for your safety. If not, you know, that bullying shit, that shit for suckers, man. Somebody bullied my homeboy, like little JoJo, when he was growing up, shot a call about that bully shit. Cause everybody ain't going for that shit.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? And Shotty ain't doing no time. You feel what I'm saying? Shotty ain't did no time about that body. You feel me? Stop. Don't play with real near. Like, some people don't allow that. You know, because I'm raising my children to, you know, in the righteousness. You
always protect yourself.
I have to raise my children the right way in order for them to have a chance, you know, a fighting chance. At the end, everybody always died. You know, everybody died at the end, you know. But I want them to understand that when you do go, man, it's a person that you're going to have to go answer to, man, that stuff's not going to look good if you're not right. You feel what I'm saying? You have to be right. You have to stand up for the right.
Real nigga shit, man.
Be righteous. Man. Be righteous
kid. And you got to be just remain a real nigga, bro. Yeah. It don't matter what the situation. Don't be no dumb nigga now.
Let me ask you this.
Be a real nigga, man.
What advice would you give somebody who's trying to maneuver, not just through the music industry, just through the industry?
The industry? I mean, you have to get ready to stand beside snakes. And you can't kill them either, because it's not the street. You got to deal with them. Them niggas be standing right cross frame, bro. You got to do a Benny while. You got to look at niggas that you would cremate in the street. You feel me? And you really can't make them moves like that because you're trying to actually have a legitimate business. You know what I'm saying? But if some of this stuff, man, it's a crazy game, bro. And if the reason why real niggas walk off saying, "But it's a crazy game," because you can't really react. You can't. If a nigga talking to you crazy on the internet, it's not. You shouldn't go shoot nobody. You know what I'm saying?
Well, no,
so since you shouldn't do that, you gonna have to deal with this fake ass nigga standing right there. You feel what I'm saying? So right. This ain't. Don't come in here thinking. Don't think you finna get coming in this shit. All funny games. Nigga, or drop your ass. Nigga with the check, a turn, bro. I done seen it. You feel me? I done seen people hop on this, man. That's why I thank God for who I am, bro. Cause when they vote you out, nigga, be right on the air. You feel me? You back on my dick. I done seen them get off my dick and back on my dick so many times. It's just like,
right.
y'all the biggest whores of them all. You feel what I'm saying?
That's another thing, though. It's like you were saying it early, but you just got that freedom as an artist to kind of come and go as you please. You
yeah,
can
because,
fuck with
like,
the industry when you want to.
Yeah,
you can
because
come back to
like,
the hood.
I'm not going to take all your money. And you're not just gonna order me around, and you know I'll make what I want to make, and you know if you know I've always wanted more, but you know I know if you gave me $50 million, I know I ain't gonna be able to do what I want to do. You know what I mean? Like I can't really. I'm gonna have to give you that $50 million back.
Right.
Shit. So now I gotta get up at 7:30. I gotta be on Jimmy Kimmel. You know what I mean? I have to go. I gotta go meet DCYOUNGFLY to shoot this movie at this hour.
Right.
You feel me? Hey, this because yeah, hey, look, I done gave you my goddamn money.
I want my money back. Yeah,
right. This ain't your life. It's my life now. Like, I mean, you know, you everywhere, but you're on my call. You feel me?
So yeah. That's the sacrifice you make.
But you have to want to do that, and I just didn't want to do that. I didn't want to do that myself. You know, I recouped everything. Like, I'm one of the artists that one of
Let
the
Let me ask you this.
I recoup everything.
Are you ready to fuck with the industry more now that you've matured?
Yeah, but you
and
know.
You see that it's a business.
And the reason why I'm ready to fuck with the industry more now because I don't owe nobody shit. You feel me? I throughout all my record deals, I've always recouped.
That's that recoup and talk.
Yeah, that's recoup talk. Like, I don't owe you a goddamn thing. Like, you don't have any money.
Young Dro is good money.
Yeah, you I'm good money.
It's like, coming right back.
If I go get a deal, they'll be like, well, you still got this deal open because you didn't say, like, no. I repaid everything you ever gave me, you know, and I do own my catalog. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You own your
catalog. And I have a great catalog. You got to check it out. It's like 50 songs.
Let me ask you, what's some of your favorite Young Dro songs, my nigga?
What I like myself?
Yeah, your shit. What you ride around and listen to out the Young Dro catalog? And can you give us some insight when you made that song? Like, what was...
What I listen to out my catalog... What the newer stuff, you know?
You know, my shit is all on their forehead.
I like the Breathe thing that I did on
Breathe.
Well, I just like taking niggas beat. You know, I did the DOA beat, like that on Death for All the Tune with Jay-Z. Yeah. I kind of like splashed on that. I really liked splashing on that.
You fucked up that Linkin Park.
Yeah, but you know, niggas out the hood were doing that Linkin Park
exactly.
shit.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? And I used to, I liked it doing that shit because I was like, nigga, gonna do this. You know what I mean? But Jay did, you know what I'm saying? I always go at Jay, though, you know what I'm saying? Just because I know that if we got in there bar for bar, I'll be okay.
I think you would, bro.
I know I would. Yeah. I wouldn't.
There's not too many rappers that's, you know.
Yeah, I wouldn't miss a beat. I wouldn't miss a beat in that motherfucker with that nigga.
I wouldn't play. I speed it up on his ass. Man, I'm like, rap fast.
That nigga done came in here and dropped so much game on us, man. Hey, we can't thank you enough, dog. This is 85 South Show. You can come fuck with us whenever you want to. We ain't kicking you out. I'm just letting you know. It is what it is, my nigga.
Appreciate it, man.
This podcast right here is for niggas who waited that whole year before the Best Thing Smoking came out and was like, man, what a goddamn album at, boy?
Yeah.
Yeah, we remember that. We remember when they was promoting Best Thing Smoking on Tripping on Tuesday. You remember that shit? That was way before the album came out.
Yeah, Tripping on Tuesday.
Tripping on Tuesday, man.
Yeah, man, I feel that.
Still fuck with Duval?
Duval still close, man. Duval always come out.
He a good nigga, man.
Yeah, that nigga, like, it ain't
Duval
nothing.
Duval got songs,
man. Yeah, me and Duval.
You and Duval got a couple songs, though, nigga. Nightlife.
Nightlife,
but shout at them gate.
Me and Duval, man. I mean, when we first met, we were joning like a motherfucker,
right?
And Tip, you should always tell the nigga, bro, my homeboy Dro, you can't like, you ain't gonna out jone that nigga. Then Duval, I mean, where that nigga at? Well, we get in the back of the car, we go out there for 2-3 hours, bro. I get that boy the bank head business, man. but ever since then, he be on go on my ass. Like, I don't know what I started, though. You feel me?
Yeah, that wasn't no thing. When you roast a roaster out,
yeah,
nigga, you do something to our soul. Like, you never, ever... not gonna get this shit. Yeah, I don't give a shit. At your funeral, I'm gonna be over your ass. Oh, but you ugly hair and you're talking ugly. Hey, fuck wrong with you.
Dro, let me ask you this, man. You know, in the industry, you see niggas fall out every day.
Yeah,
but like, you ain't never fell out with the squad or went public.
Yeah,
we have. Yeah, but you still, you know what I'm saying, you kept the loyalty.
Yeah, we didn't volunteer that shit.
Right.
Out, you know what I mean? Like, don't get me wrong. Though, we ain't always saw eye to eye. You know, me and Tip, that we used to be like, we went from hanging with each other so much until Jason Jeter was like, I gotta stop y'all from hanging. Cause shit, Dro ain't getting no work done. Tip called me in the bathroom. Hey man, look, bro, we gonna have to start hanging. I said, well, who the fuck flew me out here, Tip? Cause I don't know how I'm gonna get around this shit. You feel me? But you know, after we hung out to the point where, like, you know, I had seen a lot of stuff through Tip. You know, he really opened my eyes to, hey, bro, they ain't fucking with you unless you do this. You feel me? Niggas ain't fucking with you. Like, he was like, did my campaign? Like, they fucking with me? Like, what you gonna do? So. I was like, shit, I need no more in here. Mm-hmm. So shit, when I got that motherfucker, they started doing whatever they did. Like they were kicking. Oh yeah, so you gonna do what the fuck I say? You feel me? Shit, I want first class flight. Don't ever put me on coach going to L.A. That's like going to jail. You feel me? I was going crazy, bro. Right. Shit, y'all need a hit? Let's go. I mean, but me and Tip, we been in our relationship, shawty. We done, we got help together and everything. Shit, me and my own boy.
That's what it is. Well,
we started, but we was some geekers, boy. You hear me? Boy, we didn't play either. I'm talking about whatever new was out, bro. You know, yeah. From anything. from the cars to the best of drugs to the.
It was a concert store overseas.
Yeah, man. Hey, you talking about, man, whatever new was out, man, we were kicking it, bro. I'm right. Talking about, yeah. The new stuff we got, man, we were reflecting on growing up. You feel me? Royalty. Like, this is, it's prestige. Everything prestige. We just got fitted for some suits and shit like that, man. Yeah. We're going to be rocking $500,000 worth of clothes, man. You know, and they're going to be in a couple of outfits, like, real suits, fitted for them. It takes 3-4 months to get them bitches back. You know what I mean? Yeah, we getting fitted. You know what I mean? But the new shit going to be, but we going to be still, like, sent on Bankhead in the foreigners. You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah. Right up there. You know what I'm saying?
See, I don't think niggas understand, like, it's like, okay, you make it to get out the hood, but you always go back just to remember and refurbish yourself and humble yourself and just get like, cause nigga, I ain't gonna lie. When I was in the hood every day, I never saw myself. You know, I'm from Adamville, so you know, MLK all I know. You feel what I'm saying? So I was like, man, this shit looks so normal to me and all that shit, nigga. Once I left and did my thing and I come back and I'm like, nigga, I actually survived this shit, man.
I'm telling you,
this shit is real, bro. Yeah, like it put like a whole new sight where I see the kids now and everybody. I just be like, look, bro, nigga, you know how we got them man-made beaches, nigga, and they be salty, fuck, nigga. We got blue water, nigga. You can go to the beach and see blue water, nigga. This shit you see on TV, I swear on everything.
Man, it's like, amazing when you leave your hood and then you come back. Even the old niggas be like, hey. Listen, you got that young nigga. He been somewhere.
Hey, you got to have that card, though. Like, yeah. Niggas ain't playing, bro. I ain't seen you get ran all day spot. Niggas telling they can't come back.
You to their own hood.
It be something you done. You didn't leave right. You feel me? That's like a soul or a ghost or something in the house. It was some wrong for shit happening. That ghost in the time. I'm still here. I didn't die right. Some motherfuckers killed me. Go get him. Yeah. But, you know, I think that everything deserves a goodbye, or you know, or explanation, you know,
or you just ain't representing boys, right.
You feel what I'm saying, nigga? What's up? You ain't said nothing,
right?
You feel what I'm saying, nigga? We used to eat. The girl, I knew what you ate. Your breath smelled like this at 8 o'clock in the morning, bro. You right, Murray? You my real homeboy. Yeah, I know what you eat. I know what your mama kick you out. I know what kind of clothes you had on when y'all got the fine. You feel me? When you got your fur bomb, I know what you had on.
Right.
Yeah, but you know. Some niggas forget that shit. They never wanted to be there. You know what I mean? And them type of niggas can't never come back. Them the type of niggas can't come back. If you was ashamed of where you come from, I don't think you should be allowed back.
That's realism, motherfucker.
You didn't even like.
Cause I still be posted like in the Allen Temple. You know what I'm saying? Like posted.
I was in the hood today and pulled up on this nigga.
Shit, like the water. Bob, what you doing? Finna get some beat. Hey, that my nigga right here.
I just saw, bro. By the tune.
Yeah,
I
don't play. Like, I'm there. Like,
I just gave out some criminal tree in the tune. Like, and the girl was like, shit, he actually came. Yeah, I had like, I'm at the house, right? Just chilling. And, you know, I got the foundation or whatever. And I'm looking at the tree. And I had got a real tree. And I ended up didn't want to take care of the tree. And I was like, I'm going to get these junk away. Then I said, shit, I'm going to buy 10 of them bitches and give them away. You feel me? But I ain't giving them to nobody. You know, I'm just giving them to
that's
people.
That's going
to
set that bitch and on fire.
You talking about I went to Allen Temple.
It ain't a real tree.
I went to Allen Temple. I went to a lot of places. I gave away 20 trees.
That's what's up.
I just gave away 20 trees.
Hey, bro, don't never stop doing shit. Like,
yeah, you can't, man.
I just got my foundation. Like, you know, me and Tip taught me how to do that, though. I can't lie. Just seeing how the boy move. You know, the Hosea Project, him and Ludacris used to be, Tip used to just be the top number one pair, you know, you know, with the Hosea thing. They love us over there. And I saw how home used to take his time. And go out there. And
what was that like seeing your partner that you really been in the trap with turn into a legit multi-millionaire business?
The same nigga who said, man, these fuck niggas up here got their KFC trick.
Right. The same
nigga now.
Same nigga used to grab at KFC and to get money with him.
And listen, this nigga used to do that. Like, when he used to have us around, then he used to do everything, bro. Buy the liquor. You know, he was the only kid, so he really didn't have brothers and sisters. Right. You know what I mean? So we was, a nigga might, you know, I grew up on a different side, so a nigga, when I see niggas that used to fuck with me, I used to be like, shit, what's up? Nigga might be like, fuck with me, Dro. Till be like, what he talking about? Why, you know what I'm saying? Like, that was my real homeboy, like, you know what I mean? And then when Shotty got on, I always knew he was a leader, you know what I mean? Because, and they used to, when he came up there, when he came up there to get up for the shootout, shit, we was with a short, that nigga was like 4 feet tall, like, nigga. We was some tall niggas, like, this nigga was surrounded by big niggas with chains and shit, ready to buck by him, you feel me? And that's how it was. Tip used to be starting a lot of shit, but he be not talking to me. Sleeping with a nigga girl, running, you know. Hey, come over here, man. I think the nigga outside. Tip end up fucking this nigga hoe. Nigga come back. Not finna touch him. You feel me? Not finna touch your hand on. If we in the club, your girl get lost. You feel me? She was shouting. Yeah, leave the trip.
That's all
right. Leave the trip. And nigga want to buck. You mean the break beat out KT. Big as hell. He beating the shit out, nigga. You feel me? And we all just fine. We don't give a fuck. You know what I mean? Nigga biting everything. Who biting, bro? We biting from Bankhead, bro. Nobody want to stand all that shit. Nigga biting plugs in, nigga, bro. We get a 10 shot later, bro. I'm playing. Nigga biting plugs in, nigga. Man. The hair on you. I'm gouging out eyes, sticking my head in, nigga, nose and everything. I'm playing. We don't kick that fast shit. Spit on the nigga. What? Spit Clorox in that boy eye. Fuck you,
man. All the fuck shit, man.
We with all the shitty. We with the shits. Straight up, man. We're a Bankhead, man. But we dropped the album this time, though. It's just going to be something everybody.
Man, we looking forward to that shit. We're trying to get Tip to come up here and drop the game on him.
Tip going to drop the first, March, February, something like that.
Okay.
He's gonna drop this new album, which I'm on. I don't even know that name of the album.
Man, tell him to come up here and holler at us.
Tip, come up here and holler at us.
I'm finna call him.
No, you know DC can get Tip in a heartbeat.
You know, the atmosphere right now. I call him, man.
Yeah, that be he love D. They always get together to do some nice shit. I ain't even been out, and him and Tip they be blessing the TV, bro.
I might be like, Tip, where you at? He be like, little bro, I'm goddamn. I'm right here at the studio. Pull up. I'm like,
yeah,
call.
But shot me in the city, shot around here, got it. But you know, they ain't even been the truck around here acting a fool. Now, I just seen Rich on the car and get him one.
For real.
And them truck out 300.
I got the same letter, but it ain't a Bentley truck. I got a Buick.
Yeah, I got a U truck. I got a Uber truck.
You feel me? I'm finna sit that bitches on.
I flat the ride down to get up. And I'm like, hey, meet me now. Hey, Charlotte, come on, let me get in there. And as you do it.
Yeah, Dro, you fucked us up, man. In a lot of songs, you fucked us up. Me and Clayton been wondering for years, nigga, what is that blowfish sushi hitting like?
It's not that really good.
It's not good. No, you let me down.
It's kind of like, it wasn't that good.
Well, what that shark meat?
You can eat a piece of this blowfish sushi that could actually kill you.
Right.
Yeah, you eat the wrong part.
That shit poisoning.
It's poisoning, but
the paralyzed
piece is not, I ain't going to say it's not good, just you can't eat a bunch of it. You know what I'm saying? It's an acquired taste. I dig it.
You had us in restaurants.
No flex. We really thought you were just rapping that time.
No, for real. You had us in restaurants ordering shit.
Travis Barker we used to go there.
They ain't got. Niggas say alligator dark meat.
Yes.
I mean, Papa Do's. They was like, it just come high.
Come.
Ain't no dog meat. It's all dog meat. That's what she told me.
It's a fatty part, and it's a healthy part to every animal. So
all right.
You can get a healthy part of that animal now around his ass would be the buttocks. You know what I mean? You get oxtails. You feel what I'm saying? You can get the prime cut by the rib.
Tail.
You know, you get the back of, you did that brown, the dark meat on the chicken, that shit ain't worth nothing out of church.
Talk to him.
I mean, Popeye put a ball in there. The ghetto eat the church.
Come on, man.
But you know, with the black and the white meat, see, I like biracial chicken. Give me a white and a dark
pig. This nigga said biracial chicken.
You know what I mean?
Man.
Give me a white and a dark pig. I want a white and a dark pig. Give me some of that bi shit. I just got to have both, you know, both parts. You know what I mean?
This nigga, man.
Yeah. You know what I mean? How I eat. But you know, we used to eat that shit. Like, the reason why I eat crazy shit like snails, escargot, you know, octopus, blowfish sushi, the reason why I eat that shit because, you know, from not being able to eat, you know.
That's the type of shit that you gave a hood nigga perspective, man, on a lot of shit.
We used to go to just to eat. Just eat.
They don't know about that.
My mama knew.
Now I'm riding poking beans.
You know what I mean? Yeah, them, but you know, and don't nobody. Look, I used to love the little fat part in the bean, but you know what I mean? The little white part.
Yeah,
I'm eating that and everything. Mama save me that. I'm going to eat that white part. I ain't
bullshit. Mama say that.
Mama save me that. Cutting the hot dogs up in that motherfucker. You feel what I'm saying? We ate that shit so long. I decided to have a car that color, and I talked about every car that I could because that's them the
nigga, cars. The way you describe them shit, hey, it don't matter what kind of car it is, nigga. But when you say you got that Red Bull yellow on that bitch, and nigga got to Google the fucking.
Hey,
nigga,
the man said he had a Grape Grand National. Grape Grand National. Yeah, first of all,
Rocco had one like
that. Shit will pop a whip.
Yeah, it will. The motherfucker fast. Yes. It was like a Marauder. It was like the Marauder, the Crown Vic Marauder used to do 160 back then. But niggas didn't know that.
Yeah.
Rocco used to have these type of cars. And when he had them, I wasn't able to afford them. But I was able to explain how they looked and I dressed accordingly. Like, they used to be like, boy, you got a fine car? And I'm like, this bro car. You feel what I'm saying? But I was always fresh, though. You feel me? But it just went hand in hand. Like, if I couldn't tell you, if it wasn't mine, it was the niggas next to me. You know what I mean? That's how I was able to.
Man, that's too real.
Have credibility.
That's too real, man. Yeah. I think these new rappers need to take a lesson, bro. Yeah. Like,
I mean, if it ain't yours, it don't have to be your story. It don't have to be your story.
If it ain't like, yours,
but the whole thing is, it ain't niggas out there who real enough to admit that this shit ain't there. Yeah. That's what the game is missing.
I would have hammered down King, bro. You can give me your outfit. I'm finna iron them motherfuckers so good, bro. You're gonna be on this shit back. Like, I gave you that. Like, fuck yeah. Nigga, you know, it was a washer and dryer in there.
Fuck you, man.
And some starch, nigga. I went in with that iron, but I'm talking about glued the motherfucker together down there while they're here.
Hey, Ralph Lauren owe you. Ralph Lauren owe you, bro.
They do. And they try, but like I was saying, they fucking with me, but I gotta get rid of these cases. They're not judging me. You know what I'm saying?
Hey man, for the sake of niggas who really fans of your music.
I heard Amanda
after this shit, fuck the streets, Dro. Yeah. You gotta drop us about 3-4 goddamn albums.
I can't. I don't think but Jay-Z 47, bro.
Man, fuck that, nigga. We want flip flop, drop top, candy ride.
Jay-Z 47. I want an extra.
I'm playing that shit at my 81st birthday.
Hey, you talking about?
Fuck a shoulder lean. I don't know how to dance. That's what.
I wrote that shit in the 9. You know that? I wrote that album in the 9. Like 49 was popular. We like, what you know about Hot Top?
Nigga, that album was so fucking crazy. Right there. Creative. Yeah,
you know, but
the vibe on the whole shit, you can let it ride. You know, when you and Nitty get together, it's going to be a motherfucking fool, nigga.
It's crazy.
That Jackie Chan?
Yeah, that Jackie Chan. I mean, boy, me and Jazzy get together, it's crazy.
Who your favorite? Who your favorite producer?
To work with.
Maybe two.
Lil C.
Okay.
Jazzy, Stroud, Narden B.
Hey, Narden B, I fuck with Narden B. Them boys are
Swag and Stroud. Then Beat Billionaire, he went to.
I want to see you kill one of them BET cyphers.
I ain't no cypher type of nigga though, you know.
Yeah, but you'll fuck that up.
I mean, I'll fuck it up, but you know, we ain't no cypher nigga from Atlanta. Like, niggas didn't know how to spit. I went downtown
you'll
one time.
You'll fuck them up though, Dro.
Oh,
you'll fuck them up. You just kick that Dro shit on that beat. It gonna be over.
I know you listen to a lot of this new shit and see where your influence kicked in.
I do.
On the new wave of shit, especially.
I do. But you know what? But you know, some of your best thoughts come from others, you know? I think that, you know, just like I got it from somewhere, you had to get it from somewhere. You know, whatever we like, that's the kind of monster we are, you know? Whatever you like, you know, coming up, that's the kind of monster you are. And if you like me, and I'm part of your monster shit, you feel me? That's dope. You know what I mean? I know who I liked it, bro. You heard that shit. You heard Nas. You heard Cam, nigga. You heard goddamn Raekwon. You heard Biggie. You heard Biggie. You heard me talking about Versace's and all that shit. And I was talking about that shit when nigga was dancing.
Right,
He was dancing, talking about Tootsie Roll, nigga. I was spitting lyrics.
I don't know the answers, but I showed up late. Fabo.
Yeah.
Y'all used to be in a group together?
Yeah, Fabo used to be tripping.
What the fuck is that music, though? We've been looking for this shit.
That nigga Fabo used to be tripping, boy. We did
what
not
get along. What
used to be doing? We did not get along. I used to have to record with a strap. That nigga was crazy. I went to Banghead one day and told my girl, I said, this nigga Fable be tripping at the studio. This nigga actually be mean. Like, this nigga was trying to be mean. I'm like, I'm mean too, but I'm kind of like subtle with it. Like, nigga, you need to stop doing that. But you know, that was like my friend. We used to stay together. You know what I'm saying? And we, you know, Raheem the Dream, you know. Listen, when the nigga met me, all that other shit went out the window. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, everywhere I go, nigga, I don't give a fuck. When I get there, I'm dropping first. I don't give a fuck nobody. I can't wait, you know. This ain't no wait music. This shit what it is, like, and long as I'm sitting around and see that shit firsthand, like, I got little brothers, you know what I mean? My cousin, them young nigga, you feel me? So it's hard for me to be all point about what's going on in the street. And Atlanta is like music mecca right now. Like, wherever you want to, whoever you want to be, you could come to this city and be that.
Damn.
And blow up before niggas who really from the city.
Yeah, you can do that.
Damn.
But your drive be more, and that's not a coincidence. Their drive be better than the nigga. Like, but you know, you'll catch a nigga from Atlanta. Oh, I really don't rap. That's exactly why you ain't made it yet. You really don't do this shit. I really do this shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, you be spitting, bro. I take words apart. You feel what I'm saying? That shit you talking.
Put them together like me, like psychological.
Yeah, that motherfucking shit.
Man, stop saying it like that.
Nigga, nigga, that's stupid.
Nigga, I swear that I put that in the song. Everybody, I swear, nigga, go psychological. And won't nobody be like, wait a minute.
Yeah, they'll go with that. They'll be like, shit. Shout out to psychological. Shout out to Sasa. Shout out to Sasa. Shout out to Sasa.
We'll break the word down, Jacob. Hey, boy, that nigga Sasa.
He's Sasa for something.
Hey, you looking for crazy shit. I'm still looking for the Jag with the airplane motor.
Yeah, man. I just put wings on the cat so the Jag can fly. I said that shit on the dude was like, what the fuck you just said? I don't know. I'll go back and figure that out later.
Fuck a shoulder, bitch. I make your puss ass and titties lean.
Yeah. I told him I could turn time a day back. June the 1st, I could whip up and bring May back.
Come on! Hey!
Nigga, catch me on 28 inches in February.
Yeah, that's black history. Man, God damn it. This driving right in time for it, too.
Yeah, man. It's about time I drop something. It'll be later on this. I was going to do it in December, but...
Hey, keep the wordplay up, man.
Yeah. Man, fuck these folk.
You a fool with the word.
I can't do
that,
but do it. Like,
I'm talking about fuck these folk up. Put your feet on the neck,
but
man.
You know, when people say I slacked off on the black white boy shit.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie, you did.
I did. But you just said they went crazy.
No, I said the swag. You had everybody trying to, y'all had everybody trying.
It was a whole movement.
It was an epidemic, like, you know, the Travis Porter movement. Then when y'all came, y'all were the only one making music back then. Like, between them two little years, it was only you, Travis Porter, and Rick Kid out of Atlanta. You feel what I'm saying? So we were like, what's popping? Black boy, white boy. And that's why all that polo spirit tucking in the shirt shit came. Yeah. And look at her now. I got on motherfucking fitty jeans, y'all.
<That's>
you
crazy.
Know what I'm saying? Like, we picked up on the swag and it went crazy. But we need some of that Young Dro with the gold grill on the album type shit.
All that type of shit. We need to fuck that bitch part two. I passed out
rapping the second verse of We in the City.
If you ever want to eat a nigga beat, because we know that's what you do, nigga. That's you'll jack a nigga beat and just goddamn do the shit dirty. If you ever want to do the shit, we will premiere that shit on the 85 Side Show. If you want to come on this bitch,
whatever.
I did the day they beat wrong.
What? Y'all ain't heard that?
No, we need the link. Come on, we need the link, Dro.
Bro, come on, bro.
Put that in post. Play that shit.
Man, I did that beat wrong. What y'all want to hear?
Hey, we want to hear.
We won't put
don't,
that.
Don't tell me. No, we want to hear. Yeah.
This shit hey, going
I
want
to hear. Get that shit, nigga. Get that shit, nigga. Fuck you, man.
Skills in the building. We want to see the skills.
I want to hear.
Racks on me, that tall bread. Papa Doe eating frog legs. Hard head beans caught cancer. Physiotherapy, bald head. Hustle gang, I'm the hardest motherfucker. Spit next to head. Huncho or shoulder leaning exists. I have 50 bricks in this red Bronco. Shake the pee like I'm Derrick Jones. In Mexico, wearing a red poncho. RP to my nigga Nut. Don't forget Ned Sweet and Poncho. I'm sprouted up. That's on Tar Strong. Sweet bitch, this car home. I got major ground like on ABG. I can't wait till my boy get home. Now in L3, we gonna spray your ass. Front Street, we gonna K your ass. On the same nigga from Four Seasons, get geeked up, and I lay your ass on the concrete. I'm the bankhead, Blunt B.
Every verse that I kick, constipated. Nigga, that's hard shit. Don't front me. My white bitch, she look gorgeous on it. Sky boy got forges on it. I ain't never had a front yard. I'm from the bricks, bitch. We got porches only. Now, this bin's the same color maple. Guess what color I'ma paint the Wraith, though? Light tangerine orange. With a nigga drop a yellow shit. Look like grapefruit. As far as the boys go, I pass your ass. Get on track and I mash your ass. Man, these diamonds, these VVS, that shit you rocking like plastic glass in that Hellcat car. I turned it over. Came back through an orange Nova. Hell yeah, I got a bad bitch, but I still jack my dick thing in the Oprah.
Real talk.
We appreciate that, bro.
Appreciate y'all, man.
I like that.
I'm finna go do Norris shit, like podcast. I'm gonna go to Miami.
Drink champ.
You going to drink champ?
Yeah, tell me. He called me today.
Look, we ain't no haters here.
Nah, we fans of all the motherfuckers. Yeah, podcast.
You know, you got to be for spoke with Superdog. Superdog, that nigga come up when I was young.
And when you get there, you let them know that the motherfuckers over here, the 85.
This the first
South
one I ever did.
We fucking with.
Oh, this the first.
This the first podcast.
This is my first podcast.
This is what it is, man.
You fuck. I ain't been special.
Yeah, this is my first one.
We feeling special.
That's what it is, bro. We putting it down right here in Atlanta, man. So whenever you got some shit to say,
yeah, I'm
you
stop
got something
y'all
to promote,
okay,
nigga, you want to talk some shit.
I got
shit
an avenue.
You
want to
roast
avenue
this nigga DC. You just feel like talking shit, nigga. Pull up.
No, don't do that.
Pull up in the flip-flop truck.
You, your career. No, I ain't going to say that because you a real street nigga and you got there and roast. I was just going to say, now you going here. Don't fuck with me. I'm a career elder. Don't play them games.
I know my audience who fucked with us on the 85 South show before you get out this bitch. I need you to drop a little more sauce.
Yeah, yeah.
Some niggas who gonna be watching this shit, they gonna be wondering what, how the fuck do you pull a R&B chick? What kind of sauce you gotta have to pull you one of them R&B singers?
Yes, sir.
I mean, talk to him, Dro.
You got to have all the sauce, man. You can't even barbecue without calling me. I got all the sauce. You got 100 bucks, you know what I'm saying? You can't even barbecue. You gotta call Dro. Hey, I'm about to throw a barbecue. We need you to bring the sauce. You know what I'm saying?
Drop some sauce on my audience for me.
But R&B chick, they kind of, they like peanut butter and jelly. You know what I'm saying? That shit go together. Rapper, R&B chick.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Real talk, like, when we do R&B tracks with girls on there, it was kind of like the girl that we always liked, you know what I'm saying, when we were young. So, you know, when I dated an R&B chick, she was dope. You know what I mean? I used to sing like a motherfucker, like
all the time, like bitch, shut up, I get it, duh.
No, bro, I used to be crying, goddamn. Listen, but y'all motherfuckers, I was still singing that goddamn weird ass music. Y'all better be quiet. But them folks volunteer that shit. Them folks have a piano. Them folks and her whole family can sing. Rico Barino from Teeny, the little baby Zion, the girl she sang.
The baby,
bro, these some beautiful dog people. They beautiful. They built it out. She had a pit bull. That motherfucker got off a few. But you know, them people, you know, they know R&B shit. That's just something that I think Atlanta niggas like that shit. You know, Rocco went with Monica, you know what I'm saying? Future went with Sierra, Dro went with Fantasia.
Wow.
You know, it's just in us, you know. That's how I shout. And I always wanted to rub R&B shit. You know, it's just like the 48 laws, you know, that shit. You track certain shit.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, what if my R&B chick like ain't on? She just know how to sing like a motherfucker. Like you
that's it.
Okay, babe,
because
good,
you know she you don't know what gonna happen. You know what I mean? It's a lot of people who sleep on 7 for a minute, but shot him in hits though, you know what I'm saying? You never overlook talent, you know. You never know when it's somebody's time. So if you're out there making music, don't ever stop. Like, when you stop, we stop. We don't know, you know what I'm saying? Like, the people stop, you know what I mean? Everything stops when you stop, so never stop.
Right.
You know what I mean? Always do your best, man, and keep at it, bro. You can do anything, bro.
Man, well, once again, my nigga, we appreciate you coming through fucking with us, dog.
Hey. This motherfucker said you can do anything. This nigga jumped straight to somebody DM. All right, let me see.
You can do anything.
A producer.